Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Nitro is the glory, but Ebuggy pays the bills. We've now said that for the 200th time, probably much more than that. I'm here by myself right now because you know who's late. I literally sent a message to JQ just now, like about 10 minutes ago, say, hey, you know, we're going on in 5 minutes. What are you doing? His response was showering. I have no idea why JQ would want to be showering before what he's been doing, that he feels that he needs to shower before he comes on and does a live show. I have no idea. So we have to postpone for him, and then I have to start without him. But what's up, guys? It is show number 200. It's been almost 4 years. We couldn't do it without you guys. Please share this. Let's get this viral. Let's get people in here. I know it's kind of difficult for people because it's, you know, middle of the day for a lot. But we did this so hopefully we could get some of the European guys, and JQ wouldn't be up too late. But apparently he had to shower prior to coming on her. So please share this, everybody. Share the YouTube, share the Facebook if you can. We greatly appreciate it. We're going to get going here. We got Nick on. He's going to come on, and he's going to talk about TZO, like doing that grand launch. And we're going to give away some tires. We got some RCGP stuff to give away, like some pay-per-view passes. A UK entry for anybody that's in here that's from the UK. Maybe Scott Walker will win it because he's the only guy from the UK in here. But let me say what's up. All right, what's up? We got Neil Hase. We got Sweden, Italy. I think, no, Hase, is he from Sweden? Nanoa, Chase. What's up, Adam Ross, Canada, D70 Racing. Yeah, dude. Yeah, dude. Kyle Chasen. Eduardo from Brazil. RC Kevin. What's up, RCGP? David Bowman. What's up, Brady? Just got done watching last podcast. Thank you. I thought we did pretty good on that one. What's up, Lance McDonald? Let's get to it. All right. So anyway, guys, let me drop that intro. Let's get cracking. I think we're going to just wait till JQ decides to show up. But we're going to bring, after I do my spiel, we'll bring Nick on and we'll talk about that. So let me drop that intro and let's get this podcast going.
Nitro is the glory, but Ebuggy pays the bills. Welcome to the No Name RC Podcast. Get ready for some serious bench racing. But be warned, we speak our minds, express our thoughts, and sometimes things can get a little rowdy.
Hate, and he just was influenced by the hate coming from the left, the hate coming from the right.
And let's get back to more club racing and less of this money-grabbing book racing.
It's hard not to be arrogant when you're always right.
Yeah. See what I mean? That's exactly why people call you arrogant, Max.
You may not agree with everything we say, but it's definitely worth a listen.
And our pick, can you stop whatever you're doing?
Join your host, Leslie the Great, with co-host and guests as they get together to chat RC.
Hey, after that race that I watched this morning, I have to talk about it.
Here we go. $100 right here. $100 throw. Oh, no!
I like this.
What's up, everybody? Hey, thank you for joining us on our 200th episode. We got 72 people. Let's get up to 100, and then maybe JQ will make his appearance. But before that, I just want to say thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for all 200 episodes. Even as a little more than 200 episodes, but thank you for all the support with all the 200 episodes that we've been doing this. I never thought when we started this back in 2018, we'd be up at this number. And we are, and we couldn't do it without you guys. So we're going to celebrate with everybody that's been supporting the podcast for all these years. And we're going to have some fun. We're going to have some fun and give you guys some prizes. But you got to have your thinking caps on because we got some quizzes for you guys and questions. Like RC Jeopardy. But before I go on, I need to say thank you first off, again, once to you guys, NNRC squad around the world. We can't do any of this without you guys. We greatly appreciate the support. Also, thank you to the patrons of the podcast. You guys go the extra mile. We're going to have a separate little giveaway, little show with you guys here in a couple of days. So thank you for that. If you wish to become a patron, the link is in the written description. It helps me out a lot, trust me. And of course, we couldn't do this without the sponsors of the podcast. And there's lots of companies that help us out, and we try to help them out as well. And you guys can show them some love. In turn, that shows us some love. We have coupon codes, affiliate links. Some we have discount codes as well. Some don't have discount codes, but if you do order from them, just say, hey, I heard about this on the No Name RC podcast. So I'd like to say, first off, and shout out to Invisible Speed. We're going to be giving one of those away as the online course today when JQ gets on her. TZO 200 Tires, thanks to Nick. He's coming on her in a minute. We got a bike starting out there. It's loud. High-Tech RCD, loving my high-tech products. TNR Fuels, Mayako, Beach RC, shout out to Brent and all those guys, Lucas and everybody. Techno RC, congratulations to Jared Wiggins, won this weekend, and Techno RC was a good win for them. Lugs Racing Tires, shout out to Bryce and all those guys. G-Spec RC Tuning for all your cabling needs. Papa Willie's Traction Tonic for all your traction needs. Sumpadal USA for your racing battery needs. Racecraft USA, I see they got some giving away decals now with the orders. I need to get me some. Clinic RC, RCGP, thank you for the support, RCGP. House of RC as well. Connie's at the large scale. Euros not having a good day today. Shout out to David Ronafalk and the DR shop, Jared Tebow and JTP RC, and my good friend, the doctor, Alexander Hagberg. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We're still waiting for JQ and whatnot. But yeah, I think we're just going to go ahead and we're going to get Nick and her, because we're going to, this is like a, I don't know if I want to say it's like a grand opening for TZO, but yeah, something like that. So let's get Nick and her, and we're going to talk about some tires, and I'll give you guys some tires as well. So get those thinking caps ready, because we're going to have our first giveaway here shortly. So with that said, let's bring in Nick and talk about TZO tires. What's up, Nick?
What's up, guys? How you guys doing?
Cool. That video cut off short. It wasn't supposed to cut off that short. But anyway, how you doing, man?
I'm good. Just staying busy.
So if you guys don't know, Nick was on our last live that we done was DNC. And the world kind of got to know who you was because they're drinking 805s at DNC. And yeah. JQ looked like a midget in between us because he was in a small chair. But yeah, man, welcome to the podcast. Thank you. I know we like this kind of coincided, the 200th episode coincided with your like official launch because the TZO website's up and all that good stuff. So I said, yeah, man, if you want to do this, let's do this. Let's have some fun. Let's talk about your products. Let's talk about TZO future. Let people get to know you. And we'll wait for JQ as well. That's your phone. Turn your phone off, man. Turn your notifications off.
I did.
I can hear him binging through her.
I don't know. It's on silent.
Guys, love your collar, dude. Ed Zimlock says, I love that collar. I know. The teal's good. I like it, too. I want a shirt like that. All right, Nick. So in case you guys don't know, this is my friend Nick Hernandez. I've known him for many years. Recently became the owner of TZO Tires. They kind of came on the scene here at DNC, and they've been kind of steadily working behind the scenes during SoCal and whatnot. So, Nick, man, tell us a little bit about yourself. For people that may not have seen that, may not know you, tell us you come from a motocross background and how you came up with the name 200 Tires, TZO, and all that stuff.
Yeah, man. I raced Supercross, the West Coast Series, for a couple years. Raced the lights class. Was a struggling privateer, tried to go for it, live the dream. Dream came up a little short. I came up a little short on the triple a couple times. Had a good time doing it. And then just kind of got tired of being broke, got tired of getting hurt, got tired of racing and everything. So I walked away from it. And then But see, about a couple years later, my brother actually introduced me to RC, and we lived right by Revelation Raceway. Mm-hmm. Bought some low-C ready.
You mean your brother that I didn't know was your brother all this time?
Yeah, yeah, that guy. Well, he looks more Mexican, and I look more.
He definitely. I was like, when you got, like, this is my brother. I thought you were joking. And yeah. Then he's like, no, like, this is my real brother. And I was like, so I'm in talking to this guy. I didn't know who's your brother. Yeah, like, hey, that was crazy.
Yeah, no, it was funny. Yeah, we don't look anything alike. So maybe, I don't know, maybe I'm a stepchild or something. I don't know. But, yeah, man, just started running the RTR Losi with the orange 350 motor or whatever it was back then, and fell in love with RC.
Yeah, so you started at Revelations because I know you was big at OC. You used to go OCRC a lot. I thought you was like a pure pink pinion crusader, but no, I didn't know you.
No, I started Nitro, and then I mean, if you've ever been to Rev, it'll get the best of you. So
yeah, those pipes will get you. Those pipes will get you.
Those giants.
I watched them get a lot of people in one day at Revelations.
I mean, we just raced there last week, and I swear there was 9 people in the main. And 8 people broke. And the podium was who broke last. It was hilarious. That place is awesome.
Sweet. All right. So tell us a little. So you got into RC. I met you through, because you used to be our, when we was our first JQ warehouse, you was the warehouse. So when I got to your house and I saw that, like, it was your garage, I was quite shocked that that was the warehouse. And yeah, you were shipping out stuff for JQ, and I remember, like, you had a lot of shit in your garage too. I don't know how you had all that stuff in there.
Yeah, well, I did a little research. I tried to I always liked the way JQ branded himself in the RC. Like, it was really different, and I was drawn to it because it was very motocross background.
Speaking of JQ, he looks like he's getting ready. He doesn't wear hats anymore because he's got green hair.
Is he all wet?
Yeah, actually.
Hey, hold on for Nick. Hold on for a second, Nick.
Yeah.
JQ, please explain to us why you felt the need to get a shower 5 minutes prior to a live show.
Because I was at the track and I just got back and I was all hot and sweaty and not focused. Now I'm focused. Cheers.
I don't have any alcohol. I just have water. Cheers. Okay, so you know what? That's a good enough excuse. I don't know how you answered your phone while you were showering, so we won't talk about that. But welcome to the podcast.
That was
fun. 200 episodes. Nick was just telling us about how we met you, and he liked your style. Like, one of the few people in SoCal that like you, which is strange, you know?
No, not most people actually like me. And
That's your conception.
The ones that don't like me in secret.
So you guys met. He was doing JQ. Go ahead, Nick. Finish your story, and then we'll just mute JQ.
No, I couldn't get the car. I was interested in his car, and I couldn't get it. And I was just wondering why. So I saw him actually at Rev, sitting there working on his car. I walked over to him. He didn't even acknowledge me, didn't even know I was there, staring at his car, wondering why, I guess. So I was like, hey, what's up? And then he looked at me all funny, like I was an alien, but I was a human being. And we started talking from there, and I just told him, like, hey, I can't get your car. I don't even know where to buy it. You don't sell it in the U.S. You don't have a team in the U.S. You don't do anything in the U.S. So after about 10 minutes of talking, I got a great idea. And I said, hey, why don't I become JQ USA and bring everything to me? And it kind of went down like that. We had a mutual friend, our buddy Peter Martin, TKO Bearings, and he vouched for me. And a week later, I had cars in my garage.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember being so shocked when we pulled up. And JQ said, yeah, we're at the warehouse. I'm like,
we were doing big things in that 10x10 garage.
Oh yeah, I know. And that's and your bike and everything else. All right, so let's talk about TZO. You guys kind of launched in February. It was a good launch for you. Well, like at DNC. I know you guys have been working on your website and all that type of stuff since then. Let's talk a little bit about this. I do want to bring up some of your products, and let's add that to our stream. Oh, right. So the first one is the wing. So let's talk about that. Hold on.
Whoa, you guys
have got some new wings coming out, and I love this teal color right here.
It came out way better in person. I was very surprised on how awesome it looks.
JQ, you're muted, by the way, if you're trying to speak.
No, I just said that's awesome. They have a turquoise wing.
I know. It's pretty cool, isn't it? I just noticed that. That's cool. Tell us a little bit about these wings, dude.
So, I don't know if you know my buddy Manny.
Right.
Manny Churchman. He was really in the car scene a lot, real cars. And he's actually designed this for me. He was inspired by the big wings on F1, and he started playing with the design and tweaking it and came out with this. I mean, really, really cool wing. I wanted something that was really different. I didn't want to just make the same wing that everybody else makes.
Right. When can we expect this to be available for people?
These will be on the website next Friday.
Okay.
So going to have them. I have white too, but it, for some reason, it didn't show up in my sample pack. So what
are the benefits of this wing? Can you tell us a little bit about it?
High downforce, maximum traction, stability, pretty much everything you want in a car. I've seen it change clapped out cars to, they look like they were brand new on the track.
Yeah. Now, are we talking about your car? Yeah, your old car?
No, it wasn't mine. It was my buddy Adrian's.
All right.
Yeah. You need to send me some of those.
Yeah, I will try them
before the worlds.
Definitely. We need to change your hair color to teal too.
Yeah, that would be cool. Or black and teal. Black and teal would be good. What's up? We got a couple of guys. It's Eric Lundville says it's his birthday. What's up? Happy birthday, Eric. And what's up, Corey Jordan? Left tire. All right, let's continue here to some tires. Let's see my fancy little video. Okay, so this is what I want. I want one of these, man. These look cool.
Yeah, it's a cool color. The color is actually the one I'm wearing. The one on the screen looks a little blue.
Yeah. Yours is definitely a little bit more light. Like
more minty, more minty fresh.
Yeah. All right. So we have these. These are available as well in all sizes.
Yep. Everything will be available. Website's up now, ready to rock.
JQ, can you write TZO's website in the comments, please? Okay. What's this tire? Joseph, you are my Jamie today as well, by the way. So get your pen and paper because you have to take notes as well. All right, Jamie. All right, Tits. Like math is your show. All right, Nick, tell us a little bit about this tire right here. What's it called?
That's our 402. That's our medium pin tire. Very consistent, very stable, a lot of forward bite. It's a really good tire. Probably mostly everybody can use it across the U.S.
Okay. Let's see. Sorry. All right, this tire here, the small pin one, is it?
Well, actually, if you go back to the 402, you could actually ask JQ. He actually ran it at DNC.
Which one? This one?
Yep.
Yeah, JQ, what did you think of this at DNC?
That one, yeah. This was good because it's sort of a rounder tire, so it's a lot more forgiving. The pin is kind of similar to similar size to Reflex from J Concepts or, I don't know, AK doesn't have a tire with that size pin. Maybe the new one. But anyway, it's sort of a not the smallest pin, one step up and forgiving because of the shape of the tire. So I liked it because it was good in sort of all conditions that DNC is, from dry to damp to wet. And it was easy. I just ran the two softest compounds they had. So, yeah.
Did the Ronda carcass make it better in the bumps and stuff like that, not catching the edges?
Yeah. So it's just you sort of feel the grip better. So you're not going to lose traction mid-corner suddenly. It happens more gradually. So you sort of feel, oh, I'm losing grip, and you can control it better. Okay. So I like that.
There you go.
JQ. All right, what's this one? You can see the carcass is a lot more square than the other one on this tire.
Yeah, that's going to be our 201. So it's a very, very fast tire, high bite, really quick response, kind of similar to like a hole shot. That's going to be good. A lot of track conditions, that one works. And we, during our testing, it's really fast. You can notice the difference.
Have you tried?
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, we were at the track with David before DNC, actually. And then Nick was there and he had his tires. And then he asked us, or David, if he could try them. So he tried all the tires. And I think with this one, he had the best lap of the day. Which we didn't think so, because the track was kind of dusty too. So they looked loose, but then his lap time was super fast, like his best lap. So definitely fast. But for me, if the track is a bit dusty, then this was harder to drive than the 402. Faster, but a bit harder to drive. So yeah, if okay. that track is like dust free, then yeah, super good.
I think I'm missing some here.
Yeah, I mean, before the show, the video was on point. Now you're all over the map.
I know. All right.
You got all frustrated when JQ was texting you.
I know. I got excited. That's what it was. Let me remove this and bring up the other video.
It was all wet texting. Got all hot and heavy.
All right. So let's see here. We went through the chart. We go through the tire. One tire. This tire. But what? Why is it going to the same thing? Did I mess up something here? Anyway, JQ, you guys talk while I figure this out. Give me a second.
So I'm on your new web shop now.
Oh, talk about the web shop.
Can people order now?
Yeah.
Everywhere or just America now?
No, it should. Anywhere should. Should be fine. I haven't had anybody outside the US actually order on the website yet, so maybe you could be the first guy. You can order a case and I'll charge you.
times case of 402s.
Yeah, you can charge me. Or I'll charge you like you charge me. I love it.
Oh man, I had this all planned out and it's sucking. All right. Let's talk about the other bunch of tires you have while I try to fix this here, Nick, and try and get some video here. I had it all planned out and I messed up.
No worries. We have, what did we do? The 201. We have a 401, which the pin is really close together. Works really good on super high bite. We used it out at SBRC when we did the RCGP. Tested out there. It was pretty good.
Okay. And you said you have a new tire coming out as well?
Yeah, we have a couple new tires coming out. We have a new version of the smaller pin, the 201. It's a longer, the pin's a little longer. Pins are a little different. It's called the 202. It's going to be really fast, long lasting. We also have two truggy tires coming out. Should be ready in October. It's going to be a small pin truggy tire and the medium pin truggy tire. We have long wear coming out. We have what else? But just a bunch of new products coming out in the pipeline right now.
Okay. Let's talk about your compounds. What compounds do you have?
Currently, we have ultra soft, super soft, soft, medium, and hard, and working on long wear as we speak.
So in comparison to, say, other types of compounds, what would you compare, like, your super soft to
tires? Here's the problem. The industry is really used to having gummy, soft tires. So they automatically touch the tire, and they're like, oh, it feels a little hard, a little stiff. But our compounds are special. They're unique. They're not copied. I came up with my own compounds. So you're not going to really get a feeling for them by rubbing your hands on them and touching them. You'll get a really good feeling for them on the track. So even though we have an ultra soft compound here in Southern California, we actually run softs a lot because the compound just works for the dirt. So a lot of people are like, oh, you need a softer compound. You really don't. If you test after like testing, and testing and testing, we found out that our compounds, we run a little harder, like soft. We don't go to ultra soft, and it's unless it's like really cold at night, damp situations. So it, a lot of people got to just try them and you know, test.
Which one is this one here? So I got the I was able
401, that we used at like SBRC, where you know it was like a sugar track. It was a super high
bunch. Right, this would have been great at in South Carolina. That's what everybody was saying.
So we ran this like after RCGP, and it was really good. Yeah. And it lasted forever.
Oh, that's what else? It looks like these will work on the East Coast races too, like the race time races. We talked about this one, I think, right? Yes.
Yeah.
I didn't put these in order, by the way. And these are the these were the spec tires that were used at the RC2 for the RC2 guys in South Carolina, correct?
Yeah, yeah. That was it's similar to that. The tread pattern on the side's a little different, but basically the same tire. Okay. Everybody at RCGP was super disappointed that we ran this tire. And they just couldn't believe that this is what we picked. But then after they ran it, they were blown away by the performance of it. They were like, holy shit, I can't believe that worked.
Yeah, once they wore it on a bit.
Yeah, the feedback was amazing after everybody ran it. It was crazy. They even told me like, hey, we were talking shit when we opened the package. And then after we run it, we take it back. The tires and the compounds were perfect.
Did you try this in South Carolina, JQ? In Desperation?
No, not South Carolina, but I've tried it.
This reminds me of like a impact type tire.
Yeah, it's a big pin. It's an all around tire. Works everywhere. I ran it actually DNC in the mains. The track was so blown out. I just needed a tire that was easy to drive with maximum grip. Didn't really get you in trouble. It was a great tire.
Good stuff. So what color wheels are we getting? We got all types of color wheels, or just we getting white and...
No. If you go back, we have all sorts of colors coming in. The colored wheels aren't actually in yet. They'll be here pretty soon. We have fluorescent orange. We have a gray wheel. We have flow yellow, white. We have JQ green.
Green.
We figured, you know, there was a lot of village copycats around the U.S., so we brought it in.
He does like that Kanai look.
He does. I actually sold a couple. There was a couple junior JQs out there. They were like, hey, you have any green wheels? And I'm like, actually, I do. When I tested with JQ, we had a bunch, and they actually bought them up.
I like these neon color ones here. I like that. That's me.
Which one? The neon orange?
Yeah, I like that.
Yeah, it's actually a really cool color. I really like colors. If you actually have a cool paint job, a colored wheel will bring that paint job to life. And it's just sad that not enough people use colored wheels. I know Joe Bornhorst used a bright orange, I think, at RCGP, or somebody had like the orange wheels. I don't know if it was.
They were wheel discs.
Yeah, he ran the colored wheels. It was cool. I liked it.
So we do have a question from one of our UK guys who's gonna.
Did he just freeze?
Yeah, he froze. Look at his face.
Oh, good.
That is so cool.
Maybe a power outage.
Normal over there. Maybe a flood. What a tidal wave came through. So are we still on the video, or are we on the back side?
I think we are live. He just
died. Oh, that's cool.
We can carry it.
That's so funny.
What was he about to say?
I have no idea. But look at his face.
I zoned out. I was doing stuff.
I can't remember. Face is so funny.
No, he's out.
Oh,
I was going to screenshot it just now. Well, it's recorded.
That's funny. Were you coming from the track?
Yeah. Testing new parts for the worlds.
Yeah, I saw it. I saw the one you showed on the Mayako thing.
Oh, Discord.
The Discord?
Yeah, so trying that more today. Yeah, it's cool. Good. I think David's going to like it. More steering and rotation.
Oh, cool. Yeah. Cool.
If you know, you know.
Yeah. The hubs look pretty sick. Look pretty good. When are they available?
Hopefully just before the Worlds for members.
When is the Worlds again?
First week of September. Cool. So what is that? Just over 1 month.
That'll be fun. That'll be a fun trip.
Yep. Are you going to go? You were planning on going at some point.
I planned on going on some point, but that trip always runs on my vacation that I take once a year is the problem. I mean, it is a problem, but it's not a problem. I need a top driver to attend.
Yeah. Someone's asking if you're going to have a red rim.
No red, just that flow orange.
Yeah.
I think
red isn't that popular, I think.
Which one?
I don't think red is that popular, to be honest.
Who makes it? I've never seen a red rim. Maybe
I think DE, maybe DE.
Oh, okay.
The red one, yeah.
Yeah, actually, I seen it at Revelation Museum. They have it.
Yeah, Lefty said his internet dropped. He said that you have some giveaways or something.
Yeah. So we're giving away some tires, some T-shirts, tire bands. We're giving away everything.
Okay, so how do we do that? Do we have a question or something that people have to answer?
He was in charge of all that. I was just a cheerleader over here on the side.
Okay, I have an idea.
Okay.
So I'm going to start the timer right now and then post on Facebook or on YouTube how many minutes until Lefty is back. Okay, I'll start the timer now. So here you see, I have a timer running. And whoever is closest to the time it takes for Lefty to get back on wins. So you win a set of tires, right? Was that the idea?
Yeah. Tires or T-shirt. Winner could could take his pick, because that's pretty hard to do.
One person wins on YouTube and one person wins on Facebook. So, okay, we have some guesstimations coming in. Someone said 16 minutes. I hope that's not true.
That is a long time. We don't talk as much as him, bro.
Yeah.
All right. You guys lost all my... Bro.
Wait. So this is the actual time there, 45 seconds. So let's see who wins. Two minutes, 1:40. I think it, 1:45. So who's closest to 45 seconds? I think on YouTube it's 1:45. I think so, yeah. This 45 seconds came after I showed that. So
what are we doing here, Jakey? What have you done?
We're playing a game.
We had a game show here, like guess how long it takes until Keenan is back.
I know.
So, wait. Stop guessing already. Eduardo Rossi won a set of tires on YouTube.
Okay.
And on Facebook.
Did you write this down?
You have to do that.
I don't have... I forgot my pen.
You forgot... How much is 116 seconds in minutes?
It's a minute and...
A minute and...
And 54 seconds.
What? Yeah.
All right, 56. You're being boring now. You're being boring.
156. 156. I think that's the winner, actually.
Devin got it on Facebook, says Chase.
Devin J. Walter.
Okay.
You got that?
All right. So
write that down.
How did you give that away?
Devin J. Walter won a set of tires off Facebook. Eduardo Rossi off YouTube. Okay. it took 45 seconds. That's amazing.
I felt like a long time.
Mm.
So just to let you guys know, it's pissing down rain outside. So the internet might go again. We have a couple of questions for you here, Nick. Let's see. All right. So one was, if I was to buy one TZO tire, which would it be for the best all-around tire, U.S. East Coast?
402 would probably be the best all-around tire.
And George Chamberlain, what pushed you to make your own tire, and what is your aspirations for TZO? Well, we're just going to talk about that anyway, but go ahead.
I had an opportunity to do it. I actually came into some money and I wanted to invest it. During the pandemic, I had made an investment in Dogecoin, which is kind of freaking hilarious. And
did you at least sell them all?
Huh? To
make the money back. Did you at least sell them all, or did you still keep some? Like you said before.
I sold a lot to make enough money, but I lost my ass when it crashed.
Oh, good. I told you something.
No, but I made money in SHIB coin too, Shiba Inu. I made money too there. I made money, and it wasn't like I lost money, but I just didn't make. I'm not a millionaire yet, so that's what I wanted to fucking be, is a goddamn millionaire. And you know, you gotta go for broke. So hey, I got enough money to start a tire company, so I'm happy with that.
So you started with $2 million then, because you wanted to be a millionaire, exactly. And decided to get into RC.
It was like owning your own Supercross team. The only way to make a million is to start with two.
All right. We have, what else are we going to give away here? I have a couple of quiz questions. Let's do a quiz question. Can you give a wing away?
Yeah, go for it. You want this one? Which one? This one?
Oh, that looks nice. Whoa. That looks nice.
So, show that wing a bit more. Someone said it looks like a Kyosho, but it looks nothing like the Kyosho.
It looks nothing like one. Rotating.
All right. Ooh. There we go. That's what we have when we have producer JQ in the house. Yeah. Those look nice.
It's kind of unique how the side is there.
Yeah, it's right here. Where is it at? I can't see. There you go.
Double side down.
Double side. IFMAR approved. Worlds approved. Looks cool.
We don't worry, Corey. We're gonna take some questions in a minute, in a little bit. But we have a question. So we're going to go. Who was the person that you said one person won on YouTube, one person won on Facebook, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Eduardo won.
Yeah. He won the YouTube.
He always wins something every time we get
really.
Yes. All the time. He always wins something.
Yeah. And then it was Devin J. Walter on Facebook.
So we're going to do one face. We're going to give, how many rings you got to give away, Nick? Two.
I think I said two, and then one for your other ones.
Yeah. Yes. All right. So let's give away one wing to YouTube and one wing to Facebook. So Joseph, pay attention. We're going to go pretty. This will be easy. And this is in honor of our good friend, the Viking.
Okay.
Now, you don't answer, JQ. This is for the YouTube crowd.
I want a wing, actually.
No, you'll get a wing. So Ronald Falk just won the 2022 European Champions. Name the city and the country that he won it in. Oh, and by the way, this is like Jeopardy. You have to say who is or where it is in your answer.
What?
Yeah, like in Jeopardy, who is the answer?
Oh.
So that's the question. Nope, wrong, Matt Castle, but close. JP Sweet. I don't know how we're gonna get JP Sweet tires though. He's like in South Africa.
There you go. You're gonna have to ship that one out, Lefty.
But that was too easy. You know what you should have asked? You should have asked when did Ronnie Falk win his previous European Championship?
I should have, but I kind of wanted to pay homage to the win this week.
Or since we're on tires, you could have asked him what compound and what tire did he use.
Yeah, I think Jose Alvarado should win. He said, where is your mama's house?
I've shipped stuff to JP Sweet from SoCal.
You did or I did?
I did. Right one time, and JP, man, it took hours to ship that stuff out one time.
I know. You had me ship some shit out one time.
I know. You're going to be shipping some stuff here soon, too, hopefully. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the drama and all that stuff. Don't worry. JQ, I'm sure, has some opinions. All right, so Facebook question. This is going to be hard. What top driver's father built the baddest-ass Nitro Crusher back in the day? What's his name? Facebook. What? You don't even know the answer to this.
I don't even know what the
this
question
top
is.
Driver, this top driver, this top driver's father was famous for building a double Nitro Crusher back in the day.
A double Nitro Crusher?
A double engine U.S. Kyosho USA Nitro Crusher back in the day.
Oh.
Chase goes, who is you, James? Come on, guys. Oh, all right. Adam Ross gets it. Who is Ryan Lutz? Ryan Lutz, dad, Kyosho Nitro Crusher was in RC Car Magazine, Car Action, for like Reader's Rides. I
agree with the Revy.
So Adam Ross wins the wing. Are we going to save one set of tires for later? I think we should save one set of tires for later.
Okay.
So congratulations to those guys. We're going to save one set of tires for later. Nick, so people have questions. What's going on with TZO? Where are we going to get them? Where can they get them from? You have some driver news as well, I think.
Yep. You can just go to tzotires.com. And you can order from there. We have them at a couple local hobby shops, but just go ahead and order from tzotires.com.
All right. So people are asking about sponsorships and teams and all that type of stuff. Yeah, how's that going to work?
If you have a resume, send it to nick@tzotires.com. And we are going to open up the sponsorship program on the 1st. So August 1st. Sorry, I forgot what month we were in. Yeah, so August 1st, go ahead, send your resume to me, nick@tzotires.com, and we'll go from there. We'll check them out.
Sweet. Did you want to talk about your new driver that you just signed? Or?
Yeah, well, we've had a couple drivers we signed. We weren't really opening up for sponsorship yet, and we picked up a couple drivers on the way. First, we picked up Cody Turner. He's like a old school legend.
He's back racing?
He's back racing. He did a bunch of tire testing for us, and our tires were the best. He was faster, consistent. We picked him up. He really likes them. Breaking news right now, we picked up Steve Harris, actually. We had heard some rumors that he was parting ways, and we went testing with them, and we spoke with One Army and him, and we worked out a deal. And we, so that's kind of like our first pro. So,
sweet, awesome. Well, I thank you for you guys' support. I'm happy to see you guys succeed. I look forward. I guess I'll see you at RCGP the next run. The USA run.
I thought, yeah, whatever. I'm so confused on that schedule.
Yeah, I don't know when. I didn't even know when it is. But, yeah, man, anything you want to say? Anybody, if you guys want to check out TZ Tires, go check out their Instagram, because the Instagram is pretty badass, as well as check them out on Facebook. But more, I think you guys more use Instagram more than anything.
Yeah, Instagram, we're going to get into Facebook. There's a lot of drama on Facebook, so.
Oh, I know. We're gonna address some of that here in a minute.
We just like posting Instagram way easier, but I'm sure we'll dabble on Facebook. But people like to cry on Facebook, man. It's crazy.
I know.
Save that for the housewives.
Neo, it's still neon in sunlight. Neo, it's okay.
Jake, you're gonna get a haircut. Get back to your regular color.
When it's long enough, so I can cut the green off.
When are you going to re-dye it? Or are you not?
No, I'll just wait until it's long enough so I can cut the hair. And
was that part of the festival?
Like what?
You dyed your hair green for the all day festival?
No, yeah, actually, yeah. Midsummer.
Hey, so wait, I have a question for JQ. How many Red Bulls did you have after David won the Euros?
Red Bull and vodkas.
Red Bull vodkas. I honestly don't know, but I think about five.
Nick, watch this. Watch this. I forgot I have this. Watch this, Nick.
Yeah, yeah.
One more is all you need. Oh my God. That's left. My retirement present is so close. Where's Coelho? Ah, he made it through.
He won't.
Oh, no one of them won now.
Time.
Where's David?
Finish now.
He's done it.
Fuck yes!
Yeah.
Oh.
That's good.
Well done.
Well done.
Hey, how was your sphincter at that moment, Joseph? Was it pulsating?
To be honest, I'm more nervous watching than I've probably ever been racing.
That probably was the longest last lap.
Oh yeah.
Even when I watched it, I was like,
oh, that's awesome.
Did that guy make the loop? Is that why you didn't celebrate when there was 5 seconds left?
Yeah, he did make the last lap, so he did have to.
Oh, that fucking sucked. Yeah. That probably was the longest last lap.
You know, his body shell came off too. Like the front body clip came off. But Shock Tower has this top bar with the nose that everyone complains about, and the bar kept the body on.
Oh my God, really?
Yeah.
No, man.
That's fucking gnarly. I know JQ sent me pictures of him crying in his hotel room by himself. don't worry, I won't send him. But we were on a group chat, me and David and JQ, and we couldn't find JQ for a minute, and then he sent us a picture of him curled up crying.
What is it?
It was hilarious.
position.
With this green curly hair.
Fetal position.
Cool. That was awesome. I like
it. Nick, thank you for everything, man. I appreciate it. You guys hit up Nick, hit up TZO, and show them some support. They're good people. And we appreciate your support of the podcast and all that you do. And your successes. I want to see you succeed. And yeah, let's kill it.
Thank you, man. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Sweet. This actually gives me F1 team manager reaction vibes.
So next year, DNC, get me some 402s again and green wheels.
Why? Yeah, you are retired. What are you talking about?
Wait. Are you going to come out of retirement or are you just going to test for us?
I'll just test that DNC a bit.
Maybe he can come out of retirement when he gets 50, when he gets 40.
There's a 40-plus class at DNC.
Yeah.
Well, technically, since you're the designer, you could just have David try him out, and then you'll design the car for him, I guess, and tell him that what's that quote? They're perfectly matched staggered tires off of that Tom Cruise movie when he goes around the outside.
I don't think I've seen it.
Days of Thunder. He lies.
Oh, right.
When he goes, don't worry, I perfectly matched your tires. Just go on the outside.
And he didn't do anything to the tires.
Yeah, didn't do shit. All right,
Nick.
Okay, guys. Well,
thank you for everything, man. I'll talk to you. You guys will talk to you later.
Yeah, have a good one. Later, guys. Bye.
All right. Hey, you know what? I don't like being on this side of you. Let's pay some bills, and then we'll come back. Thank you to Invisible Speed. You have your first catch-up video starting tomorrow, right, JQ?
Yep, tomorrow. And actually, we made it over 200. The goal was 200. We have 224
people in the course. Awesome. Yes. And we're going to give one of these courses away today. You have to think, oh, we're going to do that. We're going to do that later on.
I need to set that meeting, too.
Yeah, well, maybe let's focus on the podcast. Like, you know what I mean? We got things to talk about. Also, I'd like to say shout out and say thank you to TNR Fuels here at the NNRC. We're all about that glory, and that glory is Nitro. TNR Fuels is the hottest Nitro fuel on the market, owned and operated by Chris Nelson and his family. Made by racers for racers. You can currently get TNR Fuels throughout the USA, and he is shipping internationally now, I believe. For more information or to support the company or get this fuel at your hobby shop, visit them at www.tnrfuels.com or contact Chris directly at chris@tnrfuels.com or find them on House of RC or Facebook. Thank you to TNR Fuels for all the support. I need to catch up with Chris myself and see what's going on with his project. All right, GQ. So everybody's got questions. I know what everybody wants to ask about. They want your reaction to the Mayfield testament incident or tie, and you know what happened at Divisions race this weekend. You wasn't on our podcast to recap that. So I saw somebody was asking that. What's your thoughts on that whole situation?
Do you have the video of it?
I could pull it up. Yeah, let me pull it up.
Well, two different things, I guess. So the first is the actual contact on the track. I think the contact on the track was Ty's fault 100% because that jump seemed to be difficult. I think maybe it was a bit of a blind spot, or the track looked very narrow from the driver's stand there. So it was hard to tell where the car was. So a lot of people were jumping, you know, on the inside of the pipe or way wide. So it was hard to jump perfect. Mayfield jumped really well to the inside. Ty was wide. Mayfield got ahead. Ty was accelerating from the outside, hit Mayfield's car from behind. So, I mean, I doubt Ty did it intentionally. I mean, he had no reason to. It was his mistake. It ruined Mayfield's race, obviously, because then he was out. He couldn't win the overall anymore. So on track, I think, yeah, there's no ambiguity there. It was a clean pass and then a mistake by Ty. Would have been like a stop and go or a penalty at Euros or Worlds or an RCGP, for example. Mm-hmm. So that was on track. Do you have any disagreement there? Or
I still say it looks like Mayfield got squirrely a little bit, man. But I don't really care who's. I understand why Mayfield was upset. Don't get me wrong, I'd be upset too. You know what I mean? But yeah, I mean, it kind of. I don't know. I was just more happy with the end result more than anything. You know what I mean?
Yeah. So then the reaction on the driver's stand, like, I mean, I don't really have strong feelings about that kind of stuff. Emotions run high, and then that happens. Like, had Mayfield taken his radio and punched Ty in the face, okay, I would have a problem with that. Like, you don't need to resort to violence. But that kind of anger, I think, is understandable and okay. Like, mm-hmm. It's okay. Like, I don't have a problem with that. That's fine. It, of course, it's not like exemplary behavior, like, oh, you shouldn't behave like this. Sure, yeah, but it's life. You know, like, no one's perfect. We have emotions. And yeah, I don't see like, if Mayfield was my driver, I wouldn't give him some kind of reprimand or penalty or whatever, you know?
So
put him on timeout. Like, I wouldn't do anything. Maybe I'd
right.
I might be like, you know, let's try and, you know, not threaten violence.
Can but you hear the volume from this?
No, I can't hear.
Okay, so no volume for this, but they're arguing.
You need to share with...
It won't let me. It won't let me. Not with this for some reason. But
to be honest,
when I'm looking at Ty right here, I'm thinking if that was you, right? If that was you, you would have said something at that moment. That definitely would have gotten you knocked off that driver's stand. When he was that little smile, you would have said something like, "But I still beat you, bitch," or something like that. And then I can see you getting knocked out.
I think that the best thing about that video was actually Ty's reaction, because didn't Ty say something like, "Okay," or something like, after Mayfield walked off, he just walked towards Scotty and he was like, "Okay." I can't remember if it was okay or whatever he said, but it was just like from a comedy movie or something. Like, it was just right. Just the right kind of reaction. Like, oh, okay.
I think he de-escalated it very well, to be honest.
I mean, it would have been more interesting if Gord had been there. Like, that would have been more interesting, like Mayfield getting into Gord's face. Then Gord would have said something back, I think.
Yeah, for sure.
He was just like calm and okay.
Yeah, I think he did scare. It was good to see him say, like, yeah, I don't know what that guy's problem he has. We know that these guys have kind of not really liked each other for some time. I wouldn't say not liked each other.
I do disagree with Ty's interview. He did say that Mayfield did a bonsai pass down the inside, and almost saying like Mayfield did some crazy move and it was like inevitable, or that he deserved it, or. I don't agree. I think the pass was good, and Ty made a mistake. Like, if you go back to the video and watch, I don't think Mayfield did a crazy move, crazy risky move that
Ty did the risky move, I think.
I don't think that the move that Mayfield did was one which would result in a contact most of the time. Like, I don't think there was any risk there that most likely would end up in contact. You see what I mean? Sometimes when you make a move, it's very risky and it's likely that there's going to be contact. This one, I don't think so. The only reason was because for some reason, maybe how it looked from the driver's stand, Ty didn't realize that Mayfield's on right there and they're going to hit. So he didn't give way.
Great. Dacryman, thank you for the super sticker. I appreciate it. You know what I'm more happy about is that JQ would have done something probably a few years ago, not said something. JQ would have said something.
You know what? I actually did speak with Mayfield after this, and I said, "Hey, well, at least you didn't turn his radio off, you know, during the race." And he said something like he considered like grabbing his radio and smashing it. Which would actually have been more Mayfield, you know? Like, I just casually turned the radio off. Imagine he would have just grabbed and, like, smashed the whole thing.
Smashed his radio. But I get it. Do you feel, like, a lot of people were saying, oh, these guys race for money all the time. Do you feel that the added money maybe won a little bit more? I think, this is what I think. I think that the contingency probably wasn't as great for this because it was kind of a small race. I don't know.
No. I think,
but I feel the pride of winning this race was also something that somebody wanted as well.
I don't think that this was in anyone's contingency plan. Maybe someone had, okay, if you go here, you'll get whatever because of the nationals. Maybe it was something like, okay, go to this race instead and you get the national contingency. I don't know. But if they didn't have contingency, then it was only the race win money, which was really good, actually, and probably more than most drivers have as a contingency. But I don't know. I don't know if the money really...
You think it's what happened either way?
I don't think that the money mattered in that moment.
Right.
In that situation, the money didn't matter. I mean, 5,000 this way or that way for Mayfield, is that really...
It would have been 6,500.
Break him?
It would have been 6,500.
What do you mean?
He would have won 6,500.
Why?
That was the price he would have been home with.
Why? Didn't he
won some
Wiggins with 5,000 check?
No, he got 6,500, I believe. Like he got a Wiggins got he got one check for his win or one of the mains. And I think he got a check for that. And I think Mayfield won main and he got a check as well. But yeah, the overall prize.
If
he would have won all three of those classes, of all three of those mains, he would have won 15,000. But he broke in the second one.
50? I believe. No, he wouldn't. No,
yes, he would.
No
have.
Way. No, if it's he, not.
They had a.
Can
a
you figure grand out this shit? Someone in chat.
They had a grand prize. If he would have won all three of them, if somebody would have won all three of the mains, they would have won. Okay. They would have won 15,000. They would have
gained. It's like the Monster Cup,
right?
Million, if you will.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, I see. But I still don't. I don't think that in that moment he was thinking about money. It's more just you want to win, you know. And then when your rival ruins your chance, then you get mad.
You think it's a little frustrated too? He had a pretty good 2021, wasn't too bad. You know, he's been dominating a little bit. We know, like, they've always had really race clashes and stuff with Ty, you know, and I think Ty kind of feels the same way. You know what I mean? Like, they just don't like each other. But like, Drake's in the middle of this because he's friends with Ty. And he's friends with Mayfield. Yeah. Like, I wonder how that works out for him right
Pull
now.
Up that video again. I'm going to get a beer. Pull up the video.
This guy is going to go get a beer. Pull up that video. I'm not pulling up that video. 1,500 for A1, 1,500 for A3. If he had won all five. Okay, so that would have been like $8,000. Okay. Thank you, Cody. Let's see. Scott says, if you want Mayfield and Lutz to battle out in the first lane, that's a perfect example of clean racing. Mayfield even passed Lutz the exact same way. When Ty hit Mayfield, you could see he was still wide open. He had no intention of racing clean at that point. Where was that?
Yeah, I'm not a mind reader, so I don't know what Ty was thinking, but I just assume he didn't do that intentionally because there's no reason to. You know, it wasn't
I didn't understand why would he want to.
If Mayfield wins, I'm going to lose the race. Okay, then there's a high chance that he would do it. But in the second main, for no reason.
No, in the third main.
I don't think.
I don't know, unless he saw something and was like, I'm going to go for that gap. And then Mayfield just hit him. But anyway, what do you think of one? So I was really nervous. I was like, oh, man, I think they're going to sweep this under the carpet. But they didn't. They kept the camera.
Before we go to that. So yes, Ty could have checked up. There's time. I don't know where the video is, but yeah, he saw Mayfield landed on the inside and was ahead going onto the straight. Of course, there was time to avoid it. So yeah, a mistake on his part or too ambitious, I don't know. And then
Jared Muffet.
Exactly, like my blog post from a few years ago. And I also agree with Jay Smoker here. So he says that JQ is tougher than you think, you know? And that Lefty is a teddy bear. I agree.
That's true. Of course.
And also this thing. So Alvarado says that Rivkin cut the track somewhere. Where was that?
I don't know. I actually did miss the first main. But Van Dalen and Tebow had a little comment together and a little episode on the driver's stand as well. Seth kind of walked off fucking him off, it looked like.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, they were mad about something. Yeah. I didn't see it on camera, so it must have been somewhere.
It wasn't track. Yeah. Someone showed me like a blurry image of it, like where they kind of got into each other.
Some kind of takeout somewhere.
He says Ebuggy main. There we go. Case Edwards is on. Or was that Rivkin? I don't know. Yeah, I think if you would have told me that Wiggins would have won this, and you know what? They used the nickname I gave him. I'm super proud of that.
The Wizard?
Yeah.
You know, the Wizard has ordered two books. So the second one was for someone who didn't want to order one.
Oh, maybe it's Hooks. Maybe Tyler Hooks. Who's going to JC, by the way, I'm told. So,
yeah.
All right. I know you want to talk about the event itself. Did you listen to what we talked about on the podcast at all?
No. Ebuggy main, Rivkin cut the whole step up.
Okay. Well, that step up was a pain in the ass. I will say that.
Yeah.
And I really did not like it. I like Joe's step-ups, but I didn't like it there.
Nothing like a good rib can track cut. I mean, have you seen my YouTube video on when pros cheat and it's about cutting the track? Still to this day, the best track cut I have seen is the one with Drake.
But
so they had this. They had a start.
Yes. Yeah,
start, then you turn left and you go between a big double. And then you go left again, straight, hairpin, back. And then you do a double over the start corner, right? So he crashes there. Everyone comes around. The first couple of cars do the double. And then he just cuts the track, continues as if he is doing the double.
I remember that.
It's so blatant.
I remember that.
That is the best one.
Do you think so? This brings up what Scott says. Money races need rules. Well, I think all races need rules and penalties. but definitely. So they said that they had five referees around that race, anonymous referees around there, and they were looking at video. Yeah, that's what I was told.
Did they call anything?
Yes, actually, Spencer got one of his podiums overturned because of it. It must have been for the track cut. It might have been for the track cut.
Okay.
So should
find that out.
Well, I was told that's what I was told. So I'm assuming it was for the track cut. But they did have some referees. So this event, I know your biggest gripe was kind of like mine, was no spectators. But talking to people that were at this event, it's so huge. Everybody's spread out. So you and I kind of talked about it. What we thought would be good for it would be like getting an evening show, like get an hour program and get people there, like the Rush format or something like that. But that takes like...
Yeah, I mean... If you have an opportunity to get in front of people, then I don't know if it had been possible, but yeah, if at all possible to organize something where there's like a reason for people to show up at a particular time, so there's a lot of people, mm-hmm. and then put on a show for those people. Because if you just walk up to the track and there's cars going around, even if it's a main, you don't really know what the hell's going on. If you don't know who they are and that you don't know the paint jobs, and maybe if it's a good race, then you'll know, okay, that's the leader, that's second place, and they are racing for the win, you know. But all the other drama, like, you don't really know. So if it's specifically put on for spectators and it's short and fast, it's easy. Everyone knows what's happening. So that's really what we should try to do when we get these opportunities, to be in front of a crowd. Because many years ago, like, I don't know, 10 years ago maybe, we had a race in the paddock, in the pits of a World Rally Championship, and built a track with Astro, big jumps, made it spectacular, but also ran a tire that didn't have too much grip for Astro. So it was kind of sliding, sort of drifting a bit, rally drift, you know? And then we ran many short races, short qualifying races, and each race was exciting to watch. So people knew what was going on. Like, hey, that's the leader, that's second place. They are fighting for the win. Easy and simple. So it made it exciting for people to watch. So that's really what you need to do when you have this kind of opportunity. You invite people for a certain time and you put on a show.
Yeah, and then if anything, this is the race that we kind of need to think, like, treat this bigger. Like, this is where I would get on the manufacturers and be like, hey, we need tents, and these guys need to be just in this type of uniform and this type of stuff, and you need posters. And because there's like professional other drivers of vehicles there. They were doing like autograph signings. Like, I think we should be right up there alongside with them. Treat it big.
Yeah.
Treat it big. And I hope they do it next year. I look forward to it. I enjoyed the guy, the non-RC guy commentating on it. What did you think about that? Like, take away your JQ brains, you get your racing brain, and think about it as somebody that's coming in here. Like a new person that just catches that on Mav TV and hears him talking about it. I thought he did a good job.
Yeah, I thought it was good because that guy doesn't know RC, but he's a pro announcer. So he announced well, and he, you know, sort of talked about relevant things that new people would be interested in. or people who didn't know what was going on.
Yeah, he compared it to it was good. Full scale.
Yeah, yeah. So that was good. And a similar, we had a similar thing actually here in Finland for the third national. We have this thing in Scandinavia where it's like the nationals week, and they have all kinds of different motorsports together. So there was motocross, trials, enduro. I don't even know all the different things they had. And RC was one of those sports. And what they do is they bring in the TV crew and they do a live TV show of it. Mm-hmm. And then they also put it online. And they film all the different sports and they talk about them. And what they did was they had one announcer that knew nothing about RC and then one guy who knows RC. He's an RC racer. And they did the announcing together. And it was really good because the focus was, of course, explaining what's happening in the race, but also to the wider audience just about RC racing and how you can get into it and different classes and what's so good about it and all that stuff. So, yeah, when we have these kind of opportunities, we need to keep that in mind. So we are not just racing for ourselves. We need to make it easy, accessible, understandable for the spectators and for new people and potential new racers.
I agree. Yeah, and make that show. Like
the format and the announcing and the presentation and, you know, how the drivers look and the tents and the teams and the interviews and everything, like the whole shebang. It all matters at the end.
What they would need is you there, but the problem would be that everybody would quit like within right. 1 week. Because like dealing with you is impossible, but like your attention to detail and that detail, what I'm talking about, like that as well. Shout out to my boy Kimo. He said Bermuda's in the house or something. Burma's in the house. Where's Salty Joe? Is he around? Salty's in her somewhere. Robbie Smith just popped in. Robbie Smith, don't worry. JQ was late because he got a shower 5 minutes before we went live. JQ, somebody says, videos are awesome. Wish you'd do one on camber. Do you have a video? Of course you have a video on camber on the online course, don't you?
I've talked about camber in multiple YouTube videos. Online
course. Yeah, but I think like you have like one specific video?
On YouTube, probably not. So online course has, and we've talked about them also in the lives. And actually, let me think now. No, camber is something we talked about already in the sort of live sessions for the online course. And we have homework now relating to it. And we're going to go over the homework now in the coming weeks.
Hey, how so did Joe make it up with his homework?
I doubt he's done anything, to be honest.
Guy, I tell you. All right, JQ, you know what? I think we're going to give away some stuff and do some Q&A. I think. Did you want to say anything else? Oh, somebody asked about Hooks' move. So the reason, what I've heard from my sources is that Hooks is moving to Orlando. He's going to work for JC, and he's going to be traveling like and doing what Tran was doing and Paul was doing. I don't know what their role is called, like a team manager, but like dealing with all the tires and stuff at races and whatnot. And I think he's just running whatever cars he wants. So I guess it's just got a Mugen. Andrew Morales says, shout out Mark Santa Maria. Yeah, shout out to Mark Santa Maria. I saw he did a 4th of July parade. I met, and I like what Mark does. I like his videos. JQ, let's pay some bills and let's come back and give away some stuff. And yeah, let's do that. So, you know, BTRC has been a long-time sponsor of the podcast. We thank them for all their support. We have an affiliate link. If you guys can use that, we greatly appreciate it.
BeachRC.com, the racer's one-stop online hobby shop. Choose from all the popular brands and variety in stock with super fast shipping and great customer service. BeachRC.com still has the local hobby shop feel with all the benefits of the internet. BeachRC.com is the exclusive distributor for Ultimate Racing, JQ Racing, Pro Circuit Racing Tires, Nitro Lux Fuels, and Assault RC Performance Products. So fill up your cart and check out at beachrc.com today.
You know what, JQ? We're going to give away... I know we probably don't have anybody in her from the UK. Is anybody in the UK from her? Anybody in the UK that's going, that's thinking of going to RCGP? Because we have a free entry for you guys. What's up, Marlo? So if you are thinking of going to the... If you're going to the RCGP UK and you want to get a free entry, hit us up. We're going to question for you. But I think what we'll do is we'll give away one of the pay-per-view passes. So what... What RCGP has done is they've given me some pay-per-view passes so you guys can watch the next two RCGP races live on House of RC. So this is universal. This goes to anybody. You can win this anywhere you want. And thank you, Matt Dixon, for that. We'll talk about that in a bit, the 200th episode. So we have a quiz question for this. So this first winner will be, you'll get the first RCGP pay-per-view win our pass. So let's see. I have quite a few here. Let's see. All right, this should be easy. Which English RC legend has competed in every RCGP round? Anybody can do that. No flights included with the ticket, Chemo. So that's the question. Which UK RC legend has raced in every round of the RCGP? Nope, not Boots. He hasn't raced every round. Lee Martin, James Milner wills that. Are you just using that name?
He isn't the first one.
Yes, he is. Dacry Man said Lee Martin.
Magnus Badlund said it.
Oh, Magnus said it. Okay, sorry.
Jesus. Right.
I missed it. It was coming up later than mine. So Magnus wins that. Congratulations, Magnus. You get the first pay-per-view for RCGP. Magnus always wins something. He needs to get his charger, too. I need to talk to them again, too. Are you writing this down, JQ?
No.
Jonathan says, who is Lee Martin? Lee Martin is a European champion. Is he a world champion, too? In 10 scale?
No, second place.
Second place. But Craig has a world championship, right?
Yeah.
All right. So yeah, Lee Martin is a multi-time UK national champion, European champion, and second place at a Worlds. Nino Driver. He was really good at 8 scale too back in the day.
Yeah. Also, I linked two videos that talk about Canberra. For that guy.
Oh, Jonathan says it wasn't a question. It was, see, he's paying attention. That's how you're supposed to answer it. Jonathan, Canadian driver. That's right, Dacry. He used to drive for Tamiya as well. All right. JQ, we need some questions in her. You know what? You can say congratulations, Lefty. 200 episodes. I never thought you would have made it across one. Imagine 200 episodes, Jake. We're celebrating 200 episodes.
Yeah, well, Lefty, I have an idea. Okay.
Oh, shit.
We're going to need the chat for this. So I do agree. It's amazing. This is 199 episodes more than I thought you would manage. So let's honor Lefty by listing the five greatest things about the NNRC podcast and Lefty. Like, why?
Oh,
why
no, not about managed, me, just about the podcast.
Yeah, yeah. Why has he managed to do 200 episodes? Okay, so I'll start and then
here we go.
Comments. So I think that one of the best things, which I think is amazing, you can have anyone on here and you can carry a conversation. You can talk. It's like, I don't know if you love RC that much or if you can just bullshit. Like, even if you aren't interested, you just keep
talking. Well, I do zone out with Max and you guys go in science mode.
Yeah, but I just zone out. You know, I couldn't do it. Like, I could not do what you do. So just to be able to have a four-hour podcast and talk with all these people and carry a conversation and ask stuff and no way. That's amazing. Can't stop talking. Exactly. So that's number one. And then let's see what other people are saying. So lefty patient, what the hell? I don't think so.
Patience to deal with you, yes.
Yeah, yeah. He truly loves RC. Yes. That's why you're able to do this. Jay Smoker says, yeah, you keep it real and interesting. What else? What are the good things about lefty?
And, I like this one. Podcast? Pure sexiness calls out the bush, but fucks off the haters, puts up with JQ even more pure sexiness. I like that. That's the best one. Thank you, Matt Dixon.
Here we go. Gary says his passion.
Oh, and that's cool.
Derek has a good one too. He says, always non-biased, truly for the love of RC. I would agree.
Thank you, Derek Poe.
And we have Rifa says, he goes to live races, interacts with everybody, and promotes the podcast.
Well, thank you. I appreciate that. We couldn't do it without you guys. You know,
yes. Okay. This one gets to my next point. We'll save it.
I know what you're going to say. Like that video. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I just recently got back into RC. Podcast helped me understand how the industry has grown.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Yeah.
Scott's answer.
What's that? Inability to stop his verbal diarrhea.
Thanks for picking me up at Heathrow, Scott. He told me to fuck off. He didn't really? Say no.
The patience to deal with JQ has been the key to Lefty making it this far.
I like Dacry Man. He's a nerd that ties the RC world together. Boom. Thank you. And this guy, and he run them boats. He shoots from the hip. Not as much as JQ.
Okay, so we kind of get the picture here. Neo says, I think he has passion for humanity. I see that here in Italy. So you must have made a good impression in Italy.
Oh, Italy was nice. What's up? Pope. Hey, Pope, I sent you a new Facebook messenger, man. I had to get a new Facebook. Hit me up.
Robbie Smith says, somebody has to be the positivity to offset JQ's negative ass.
That's true. The yin and yang effect.
Okay. So we have a lot of positives there. Now we get to my favorite. What's that?
Very good at having an opinion no matter what and validating others' opinions too. I think that I can understand both sides of the spectrum, unlike you.
Yeah. No, because if you're wrong, then you need to figure that out.
Oh, good Lord.
So now we get to my favorite. So let's rant about what needs to improve for the next 200 episodes. So Lefty, what do you need to fix?
Finishing sentences.
Yeah, but okay, let's find that comment. It was here. The reason he's managed 200 episodes is because he's never actually finished a sentence. So if you're new to the podcast, you might not know this, but if you've listened to more than one episode, you'll know. Lefty has a point. No one knows what his point is, right? No one knows. Just he knows. He starts explaining his point. Halfway through the sentence, just before he gets to his point, he gets carried away and starts talking about something else.
I know.
And then everyone is left hanging like, what was your actual point? And then he's on to something else and it's done. It's gone forever. So
I know, ADHD.
That is quite amazing. That is a skill. But that doesn't really, that just makes it more personal, the podcast. So most of the time it doesn't bother me. But one thing that you know bothers me. Do you know what I'm going to say?
When I don't ask the questions that you want me to ask?
Not like I want to ask, no. It's like you have someone on and you ask them something or they say something. It's like the most obvious situation where you should ask a follow-up question and you don't. And you just go to the next thing.
Because
that
pisses
me off.
I know. I've tried to work on that as well.
You know, like someone just throws something out there. Someone says something ridiculous. Like, what could it be? It's like, let's say that it's something technical. Like, yeah, I put these tires on and I was like 1 second faster. And then you just go to the next thing. You're like, well, what fucking tires did he put on? Like, it's so obvious. Like, just fucking ask. What
that's your science nerd brain.
No, no, but that's just one that's example. But it can be anything, right? So that's number one thing you need to improve. Follow-up question.
Okay, I agree with you
there. Someone put something out there? No. Ask some follow-up questions. So now in chat, what are the things that No Name RC Podcast needs to improve for the next 200 episodes? So here's one. Fix Lefty and JQ's internet.
I have good internet. It just drops. He has shit internet and won't get any more. I'm actually thinking of putting another line in her, just like a different company, because it just keeps dropping. That's my problem. Yeah. It drops.
Yeah. Yeah. My internet, it's not going to happen.
Yeah. You live in the woods somewhere.
Yeah. Do short race recaps as individual shows for those of us that couldn't watch or attend. I actually agree with this.
But we do that. We have been doing that.
You do that? I'm never on that.
We've been doing like an hour at 20-minute recaps.
Yeah. But it's... is it a separate show or still called the same?
Yeah, yeah. We was doing like... If there was a race on the weekend, we'd get it out like a recap Monday or Tuesday. Yeah. We've done 10 scale, all that stuff.
Oh, okay. I missed that.
All right. I prefer, I would agree with Morgan Motorsports as well. Stop saying I agree if you then bring up alternative point. It cracks me up. Because I don't really probably agree with him at that point. I'm like, yeah, maybe that is possible. Yeah.
This is the other thing. The second thing, what this guy's saying. You always, you say something and then if someone disagrees, you say that you actually agree with them. Yeah, yeah, actually, yeah. Just fucking, if you have an opinion, stick to it.
Because I can see both sides. I'm wishy-washy like that. But, go fuck yourself. But
you always try and be so agreeable. Like, you just say something and then someone contradicts that and you're like, yeah, actually, you know what, I agree.
Because no, then maybe you don't I might agree. Have changed my mind at that point.
No, you didn't. You're just too agreeable. So you need to, like, figure out what the hell you believe and you think and then stick to that. You can do it politely. I don't do it politely, but you can.
You know? I think I did it. I think I was polite on the last podcast. Yeah. Will you have a name? Never. That was
what?
Will we this ever have a name for the podcast? Yeah,
the No Name RC Podcast. That's the name.
I ain't buying it half the time. All right. Yeah, that's the name. That was actually interesting how we came up with that. Good. Lefty managed to build positive relationships in RC community. The site that is a that's true. A lot of people would like, I don't like JQ, but I like you.
Yeah, but this is like I said, the people who don't like me actually like me, but just don't admit it.
No, I think people actually just don't like you. You just don't want to admit that. You just want to admit that. But I think the general opinion in you is changing a little bit, maybe because you're doing some good stuff in RC. All right, you know what? We need to give away some more stuff. I always did
good stuff in RC.
Did you have any more complaints about me, JQ?
Let's see if there are good comments. Yeah. You should hear him complaining about you after about 200 messages. I still don't know why he's mad. What he's mad about. This is so true. Keenan, you should change your hair color, just like me.
This is what when I'm interviewed, I think Lefty sometimes disconnects from what he's just said so he can follow his script. That I do have my script there, yeah, and I'm trying to.
That's what I'm saying. The follow up questions. Mm-hmm.
Let's this talk about some of the happen. Things that you can do.
This is never going to happen. Make the discussions a little more organized and concise, Zach. I'm sorry, but that's never going to happen. I think. Lefty is very disorganized.
Yeah, I'm organized to arrange trips, though. I'm very more organized in those type of things than you.
Hey, Walter has a good point. I should actually be paid to be here. Because I'm not paid. I have to pay.
Yeah, you make me nervous. Like, you are late all the time, all the time, all the time. Even today, like, I was just, like, so upset with you. so upset with you. Have you figured out how you're going to give away? You know what? We're going to give away some tires after this. We got one more set of tires. I think we got a t-shirt or two. Let's see. I also believe managed creates positive relations. He's just not advertised. Yeah, I agree. You've got a lot of positive relationships. You just end up pissing people off indefinitely. Awesome. All right. You know what? We're going to do some more giveaways after we come back.
Wait, this is a good one. We need to limit the number of messages Keenan can send in one sitting. Yeah, this is true.
Angry. I'm thinking, and it's just coming out as I think. It's like, I know you hate that. I hate that. I know you guys hate that.
Yeah.
JQ's too binary. Typical engineer brand. Yeah, he is. He definitely is. He reminds me of a lot of engineers. Hey, you know what? We got some bills to pay. We got a couple of bills to pay. Thank you to TechnoRC. Congratulations to the Wizard. He won this weekend.
TechnoRC. TechnoRC. TechnoRC is a premium manufacturer specializing in 8th and 10th scale high-performance off-road RC buggies and trucks. Visit www.technorc.com for a complete catalog of their products. TechnoRC. Excellence in engineering. Hashtag Techno Takeover.
And thank you to Techno RC for their continued support. JQ, let's give away a set of tires. This is going to be open for Facebook or YouTube. We got one last tire. We got a party going on outside. We got music going on and everything.
200 episodes.
No, but that's not me. That's the people outside. All right. So let's see if you people can get this one. No, that'd be too easy. All right. Here we go. We're going old school here. Where was the first DNC held? What year was it won and who won it? The first person to give me that answer. What year was it run? And it'd start. If you guys can answer that, you will win a set of TZO tires. All right, you're almost there. You gotta name who won it. You gotta name who won it as well.
Well, why would you say that? You're so stupid sometimes. Seriously.
They don't know who I'm talking about.
Yeah, but they are supposed to know both things. Right,
you gotta say the year, where it was, and who won it. Who won 8 scale nitro buggy?
Yeah,
Greg wanted me to go deep and say who won 10 scale gas truck.
No one remembers that. Mayfield wasn't racing then, or at least not.
So the question is, when was the first DNC? Where was the first DNC? What year, where it was held, and who won 8 scale buggy that year? Jay, I can't believe you haven't figured this out, Jay. Guys are just answering. Wow, this isn't that hard. Jay, you can't figure out. No.
You know, Jay Smoker has the shirt probably from the first race, but he doesn't even know the year. Tony Hawk, says someone.
No, nobody's getting it. Nobody's getting it right. I don't know. Maybe we're going to have to change his answer.
No. Someone's going to just leave it. Talk about something else.
All right. So almost got it right. One person's almost got it right. But they have. Trust me, you can't find it on the internet. Nope.
So private chat. Send me the answer in private chat. I can't remember who won it.
Nope. I know everybody's looking on the internet because I was looking for the answer on the internet, but it's not right. It's not right.
So anyway, what's next?
What's next? I don't know, JQ. What's next? So what has been, you know what I was listening to the other day? The Keaton Forbidden Rant. I listened to the whole Forbidden Rant.
So there's one rant that we, back when Jeff Keaton was still on, we had some epic rants. I really enjoyed those because he was very passionate and very wrong. And I was very passionate and right. So they were awesome rants. And there's one rant that went just so far off the deep end that Lefty didn't want to post it. Can you believe how personal and bad must the rant be that Lefty decides, we can't post this?
Actually, you decided that too. You said, we can't post it.
Yeah, maybe I did. After re-listening to it, like, Keaton, I don't know about that.
But you know what? When I look back on that rant, a lot of what he says come into fruition.
Really?
Yeah.
Send
like what he said about you.
Send it to me.
I will. I have to send it to you.
Yeah.
All right. So nobody's answering that question. Somebody's almost got it right. You guys are getting it, almost got it right. I know where you're looking up the answer to because I looked it up. Nope. I looked it up today. And again, that was the answer, but I had to go deep and talk to veterans to find out when it really was because I knew it wasn't that date. So you guys are close. We'll keep going. I think we're going to give away some.
Why do people think that Lutz was winning back then?
He was still young back then.
I never even heard of Lutz back then.
No, you're wrong, Smoker. You're wrong. You're wrong. You're wrong. Everybody's looked at the same thing. They looked at the same RC live RC post I was looking at today. That's what's happened. JQ, what has been one of, I know you haven't listened to all of them, but one has been probably one of your favorite podcasts. And actually, I like to ask the people what was their favorite one. I think my favorite one, the most popular one still is the Ryan Mayfield one, I think.
My favorite one is whatever the one was where we had that mega rant about RCGP and Bornhorst and you podcasting and that. And I was living in the Philippines still.
That was awesome.
Like mid rant, the doorbell rings, you remember? Like,
Oh, dude, I think. That? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, that, your food came or something.
One. Yeah, that was the best one.
I think one of your best sayings is what Matt Dixon said when he was talking about when you and Max went to the 10 scale Euros and everything had to be quiet. And he was like, it was like hairdryers going around the track. I think that's one of the most epic things. You've said some crazy shit on this podcast. So have I.
Hey, by the way, why are there no sound drops? That's it. The next 200 episodes, I want sound drops. I want you to press a button and a sound drop comes on. So when we are discussing something, then you have a suitable sound drop. You just press that and it comes on. We need that in our lives.
You know what? I'll send you all 200 episodes and you can go through them all and get your sound drops.
Listeners can...
What has been you guys? Nobody still wants. People have come close. I think we're going to have to change the question or just go to a different question. Nobody's got it. Nobody's got it. People have come close.
Yeah.
So I know everybody went to the internet to look this up, and it wasn't. I know. I want to get John Hazelwood on the podcast. I've asked him many times. So the answer was, people came close, 1999, Hammett, Richard Saxon. And if you want to know who won 10 scale rock, it was Chad Bradley. So nobody wins that. We'll get you another we'll get another question for that in a little bit. We're going to give away some RCGP. Oh, yeah. That's become a gift. That's been fun, too. I forgot all about that podcast. That was...
Yeah, when we surprised
I knew something Lefty. Was kind of happening, like, but I just wasn't sure until I saw it actually happen. Like, you know, in deep down in my gut, I'm like, no, don't get excited, Keenan. You've had these feelings of you know, grandeur before, but JQ's always fucking disappointed you, but you didn't disappoint this time.
Okay, now finish that sentence that you just cut halfway through.
What sentence? About what?
I don't know, some prize or RCGP or something. You were going on about something.
Yeah, we're going to go in to do some RCGP prizes, but we're going to have to find out another question for this. But I wanted to ask you about that stuff. You brought up that podcast.
Yeah, you started reading the text on screen. That's what happened.
Stop distracting me, JQ. Stop distracting me. You just like coming on her and distracting me and making me nervous. You're just always just being a fucking asshole. Just stop it. Fuck, man. You won the Euros and you're still being a cunt. Jesus. Did I say that live? Yes, I did, because you're getting on my nerves. Oh, my God. All right. You know what? So we're going to give you guys another question to win the tires. Let's see if... All right. This should be easy, because I'm trying to keep this American for today. What iconic track has the nickname Home of Tuesday Night Nationals? You win a set of TZO tires.
Tuesday Night Nationals.
Yes. What track is known for having the famous quote, the home... All right. So Steve Harris... You can't win TZO tires, Steve Harris. You're sponsored by TZO.
No. Just pick the next guy. Dude, not Jay either. Matthew Kessel.
Matt Kessel. You win. You win. Steve, you ain't getting them because you're sponsored by them.
Yeah.
Matt Kessel, WRC team manager. Shoot me a message, good buddy.
Yeah, guys, Jay Smoker got it, but he can just get them anyway.
Do you guys
He's
have
right
any...
there with Nick. Nick can give you a set of tires.
Just look, are you even racing? You ain't got no OCRC anymore. Are you racing anywhere? I have a trivia question dedicated to Smoker too, by the way.
Oh, you do?
I do. So
okay.
Oh, K says I was after Steve. Let's see. This is the problem.
Why? They don't go in the right order here?
No, let's see. Steve Harris. No, Matt Kessel was after.
Oh, yeah, at least
Matt Kessel was. Yeah, you was after Jonathan Hilton, Case. You was after Jonathan. You know what, JQ?
What?
Have you figured out how you're going to give away the Invisible Speed course yet? Because you have 20 minutes to figure that out.
Okay, so chat. How are we going to give away an Invisible Speed full course?
Give us
suggestions how we are going to determine who gets a free full course.
You know what? We're going to give away some RCGP pay-per-view passes and a House of RC year membership here in a minute. That's what we're going to do.
RCGP loves Great Britain. So much so, on August the 5th, 2022, we're coming home for some British hijinks and all-out Nitro Buggy racing action. Late!
Who are you talking to, JQ?
I think that I got sent that Rivkin track cut. Yeah,
it is. Oh, yeah? Can you put it up on video here in a little bit? All right, so...
my phone. I don't know how I'll get it.
Send it to me. And I'll get it up here. Send it to me. All right, so thank you to RCGP.
It's pretty bad.
Okay, well, let's try and send it to me. All right. So we're going to give away, this is mostly for anybody that's attending. Guess how long Keenan can go without interrupting you on a rant. You know what, Scott? You have a chance.
You just interrupted yourself. Do you see what we're dealing with here on the podcast?
Because it's comments.
You just interrupted yourself again. You don't need anyone else to interrupt you.
Will you shut up for a second?
You are blaming me for interrupting you, making you nervous, and ruining the show.
Because you make me nervous.
I was just quiet, and you interrupted yourself. There you go. You don't need me.
Because I can't do two things at once. I'm reading the thing, and I'm talking. Dude, when I'm texting somebody, I'm literally talking while I'm texting.
Wait. So since you interrupted yourself, here we go. To win a free Invisible Speed course, you have to... name Jay Smoker's three philosophies of racing.
Philosophies of velocity. Get it right. It's not philosophy of racing. It's three philosophies of velocity.
Okay. And Jay is actually on here, so he can verify that they're correct.
That's right. Okay, so you've been in invisible speed.
Three different ones. What are the can we make it easier? The topics.
The topics for it?
Yeah, like there's a. I mean, there's a word for each, right? What were they?
Yeah, one is
drift. Drifting is one.
Yes, breaks is the other, and practice is the other.
What's
breaks is the other comment, and practice is the other comment.
There are three philosophies. One has to do with drifting, one with breaking, and one with practice. And these are Jay Smoker's philosophies of velocity. So if you get those right, you get a free, full invisible speed course.
Okay. All right.
Okay. So Adam Ross, out the bat, roll one, smoke one, and no. So drifting, breaking, and practice. Oh, Buggy Brent. Sandbagging.
He's running
like sportsman after 25 years. Okay, here we go. Never lift and brace the drift. Okay, close. Practice is for people who don't know how to race. Okay, I would give like 1.5 out of 2.
Okay. Oh, no, he got them.
Well, it's not no, brace the drift.
Embrace the drift. Embrace the drift.
So, but anyway, it's like 1.75 of 3.
Brakes are for pussies. Never lift. Embrace the drift. Practices for people who do not. Yeah, he wins. He wins it.
Yeah, man. My man.
Congratulations. I know who that is, too. He was at RCGP. He's taller than you.
Yeah?
Yeah. All my friends seem to be tall. And then we look like the number 10 walking down the street. So, wow, he got it. He's been listening. Very well. Very well.
Okay. Well, I mean.
So let me write that down now.
Lefty can't read, so it's fine, but it's okay. You get it. I'll give it to you.
Yeah, he got it. Like, nobody else got all of that.
Yeah. Atkins has the right one here, look.
Embrace the drift, never lift.
Never left.
Left.
But anyway, it's close enough. Wow, they listen, says Jay.
What do they do? Jay, but that wasn't going to be my question for you. But you know what we're going to give away?
The drift, never lift, I think.
I'm doing voice to chat. All right.
Yeah.
So we're going to give away a House of RC full-year membership. It's a premium membership for House of RC. It's a value of $60. I want to thank Connie Svensson for this donation. He hit me up. He's having a rough time at the fifth scale Euros, dude. He sent me some pictures. He's having some beer right now. Probably not now, but he definitely had some beer.
This guy that won, I just need your email. So email your email to the podcast or something or what?
Well, I know him. He'll send it to me. I know it is.
Okay.
I know it is. So we're going to give away the
Neo is asking. Neo is confused. Neo doesn't know what's happening. So Jay Smoker is... ridiculous guy who lives in Southern California.
Oh no, we have a voice note of Jay Smoker actually.
Philosophy for racing. His philosophies of velocity, and they are: brakes are for pussies, practice is for people who can't race, and never lift, embrace the drift. Is that right, Jay? So that's what we're talking about.
Yeah, here you guys go.
This is the ridiculous one, Jay Smoker, and you're listening to the No Name RC podcast. Ridiculous!
That's Woo! Jay.
That is the ridiculous one. If you ever heard us say that, that's who he's talking. It's actually a great three philosophies. And he adheres to all of those because he doesn't practice, he doesn't use brakes, and he definitely embraces the drift everywhere he can. So, our next giveaway is going to be, you're too close to the mic. I'm hearing feedback, JQ. Next giveaway is going to be for House of Arts premium membership, value of $60. Thank you to Connie Svensson. And we're going to do it, being as he's European, we're going to do it this way. Who are the two European drivers that have won two major off-road American races in the last 5 years? You need to tell me who they are and which races they won. And I should say what year. Two European drivers have won two different races in America in the last 5 years. Nitro Buggy, yes. Sorry. Just wanted to clear that. And Yeah, there you got it. Boots and Ron Salk.
Weren't they supposed to say the years or something?
No. Oh, no, no. He's got the names, but he has to give me the races. Sorry. Yeah. You don't have it, Walter.
You messed it up again.
Every I get excited.
Question you manage to mess up.
I get excited. What? We have some spam coming in here.
No, it's just Manuela from Spain. She needs 850,000 euros in her bank account in France. She wants to give it to an honest, serious, and trustworthy person. She's a widow of 17 years, no children. She just wants to give that money away. She has
no cancer. There we go. Answer all our problems,
right? Yeah.
There.
So whoever answers this question correctly gets 850,000 euros. Wow.
RC Jerris is the first person to say them correctly. Rana Fogg, DNC, Elliott Boots, Silver State. I helped Boots win that race by saying do it for the Queen.
Yeah.
I think so. I definitely think so. So, RC Jerris, you win a one-year membership of House RC Premium membership. Sorry. I'll figure out how you do that. And we'll get in contact with Connie, and you can do that as well. Do you guys have any questions before we go in and give away some more RCGP pay-per-views? I think we need to do some more giveaways because we're running out of time here. So we got RCGP pay-per-view coming up. You get to watch the last two races live on House of RC. Jeff Werner got to S-Works for Boots at that time, Jeff. Sorry, reading questions. So we're giving away an RCGP pay-per-view pass. And we're going to get, it's going to have to be an RCGP question. So let's see. Can you name the three RCGP media partners? And you'll win a pay-per-view pass. That, can I name them? Oh, there we go. Can you name... There are four of them, officially. Can you name all four of the RCGP media partners? And you will win a pay-per-view pass. That's the fourth one. Lefty, don't fall for it. Otherwise, you'll have your bank account hacked as well. No, you got to name the actual... Companies, sorry. You got to name the actual companies. So there's four companies that make up the media side of
four.
No, it's just two. It's three.
No, but there is four. So
yeah, but
it needs to be four.
Yeah. And House of RC isn't one, but
now he has it. So House of RC, RC Racing TV, Control, and Circus.
There we go. And actually, there's one more. It's really five.
Well, it's not media, really.
I'm not media. We're not media.
You're a partner.
Yes, I was actually in that answer. Nobody thought of it. So, but ads, you get it. You get a pay per view. Yeah, RC Jerris almost had it right, but he forgot Control because Control is separate. Lefty, I am the media. Nah. All right, JQ, we're gonna have some Q&A. You guys got any questions for JQ
before we wrap up? Yeah, quick Q&A. It's 1 a.m. I need to go to bed.
Yeah, he doesn't need to go to bed. We can keep him up as long as we want.
I have that podcast t-shirt on.
I see that. You have the old one, though. You need to get the new one.
Wow, this is the good one.
Yeah, that looks brand new, too.
I washed it. It shrunk in the wash.
Yeah.
I don't want it much.
Corey Merritt. What's Corey? How you doing?
What's up, Corey? Biden sucks. And what does his shirt say? I can't see that.
That's Corey. That's for sure.
Yeah. It's the right Corey.
All right. So let's see. First RC, JQ, for you.
First RC car? I saw Tamiya lunchbox. That yellow.
You had one? Oh, that's cool. Truck.
Yeah.
I had a Kyosho Ultima station wagon. You know what I was using for shock oil? No, what? A Kyosho Ultima stadium truck. Sorry. I was using actual motor oil for shock oil.
Okay.
Because we were just racing on the road.
Yeah.
How many breeds have you had? How many brands have you had? I guess it means brands. Have you had? I don't know. I got
brands. Well, yeah. Let's just invent the question, how many brands that I've raced. So let's just take 8 scale. So I started with a Kyosho MP6. Then I had a Hobau Hyper 7. Then I had an X-Ray Bob, the 808. Then I had an Ishima for a little bit. This X-Ray and Ishima were while I was trying to get my own car made. Then I had a JQ Products buggy, then JQ Racing buggy, and now Mayako. So that's it.
Okay. Walter wants to know, who's going to be the world's top? Oh, wow.
Corey's,
I hope you're
hardcore. Corey just through chemo. Through chemo.
Keep it up, Corey. What's, keep it up.
Yeah. He should be, should have a fuck cancer shirt.
Yeah. That's what we should have. Fuck cancer.
Shit.
Dude, he's hardcore. He was at Silver State, like in the dust and shit. I was like, man, Corey.
Yeah, it's like half of Corey was missing last time I saw him.
He lost a lot of weight.
I'll see you at DNC.
Yeah.
Get rid of that cancer shit.
Yeah, keep up that chemo, dude. Let's see you at DNC. Man. Who's going to win the world's top three? Ooh. Yeah, top three, real quick.
Well, I think that the top three drivers for that race, going into that race, the favorites, they are going to be Ongaro, Kanas, and Ronnefalk. Those three drivers. That's what I think.
I wouldn't argue with that. Those three.
That order?
I it's so many people that I could throw in there. Like this.
You know the order, but I'm not going to say it.
Right. But what American do you think can get in that mix in that top three?
An American that will contend, I would say Ty.
But Canadian.
Yeah, but Roar. He counts. Like fake America. Canada. Better America. Just
pissed off all the Canadians. Thank you.
Canada is a better America. It's like care a bit more about humanity. Mayfield, he seems to always find a way to be there. So I have to say Mayfield.
Fend?
TLR have a new car, so I don't know if they've figured it out, but Fend and Cavalieri could be those kind of drivers that figure it out, but I don't really want to put them up there. So I won't. So far we are at Mayfield and Ty, if we count him. And maybe that's it, actually. Who else is there? I'm trying to think.
What about Fuller?
No.
You don't think? I do. I think Fuller's going to be in the main. I think he'll be in the main. No.
I don't think so.
Really? Wow. Okay.
This is very different to America.
Speaking of new cars, do you see Techno is releasing a new car too, right?
Yeah, but it's not a big change, is it?
I think they use some of Seth's stuff, what he was using, like Seth Van Dalen's modifications. That's what I was told.
That was for a while.
Yeah, but now it's like going to go into production or whatever.
Yeah.
Mayako Truggy, Matt Dixon. Mayako Truggy for DNC 2023.
Yeah, we should be running my truck. I have a chassis.
Let's see it.
That's a truggy chassis.
It's your future e-truggy specialist.
Nice.
E-truggy specialist. Thoughts on two-wheel drive gas truck. I think it was a great class for back in the day for people getting into RC. I think it taught throttle control. Truggy kind of ruined it and took over it. And then also the tracks just got a little bit too gnarly for it, I would say. I do like the Ignite design conversions that we have nowadays. I have a couple of gas trucks back there, as you can see. I think those cars do pretty good. So
someone
it's good
said,
to see some classes.
Someone said Chrono, but I never ran Chrono.
Ah. All right.
I haven't never ran it.
Jonathan Wolf, JQ, was winning the Euros with Miyako and David your proudest moment in RC?
I mean, it was definitely the sort of highest achievement, as in best result. But maybe the proudest sort of personally was making the Euros main with my own car. Because I had made Euros mains and done well. And then I quit, basically, and made my own car. And then had not that great results. And then I made the main with my own car in Austria 2012. So that was, maybe that, like, personally was really satisfying. Because, I mean, there are a lot of people who race and even practice a lot and they take it seriously and they never, not just never win, but they never even make the main at the Euros, because to make the main is kind of a big deal. It's like how many races in Europe and 150, 160 people at the Euros, and to make the main there, it's a big deal. So when I made it with my own car, yeah, that I'll never forget that. That was
that 2017 or?
I ended up making it a few times, but I first made it in, I think, 2012 in Austria, Fähring.
Okay. So, that's where the fifth scale, the large scale race is. Odd track, odd driver stand.
Yeah.
What was your, Gary Wright, what was the first part you ever designed, Joseph?
Shock tower, but it was for Hubao.
You love designing shock towers.
Yeah.
Coach, I want to know, Jakey was a girly, hockey girly. Any hockey fights?
I did punch a guy once and I got a penalty.
Punch him with a glove or like?
With my, is it shield in English? So that... Whatever the, yeah, what is it?
Like
Yeah. So he, like, I don't know, he kept like skating into me and like annoying me, you know? So then one time he did it and I just punched him in the head and got a penalty.
I couldn't imagine that. Crap, what has been your longest break from RC and what brought you back? I don't think you've had any breaks, JQ.
No, I've never had a break.
I have. I think my longest break from RC was after my accident in 2005. And I was like, oh, I'm not going to be able to drive anymore. And I moved on her. And then I found RC again. And I found like, oh, I can put a lanyard her and I can drive. And then it kind of died again her. So it's been a couple of years. But when I got back in 2014, what brought me back was, I think I watched the Worlds. I was in England. I watched the Worlds, and I was like, I'm in England. I'm going to go racing, and I ended up going racing. But I haven't had a break since then, I don't think. It's been good. It's been hardcore ever since. It's been hardcore. Walter, what sponsors will you have for the next 200? I don't know. I hope we get some more for next year. We need sponsors. Can't do it without them. So we need them. Ads, give the membership to a youngster. I already have a yearly pass. Hey, if you are going to RCGP though, Adam, you got the free pass. You've been a big supporter of this podcast, and you always support me. You get the free entry. Did it like the only person from the UK and her.
Do you remember this race?
Yeah, I do. It's in your video.
The one year at Neo, the last chance I started, I was going to start second. I think Tagesi was supposed to start first, but he broke or something happened. So I had the lead and I was leading, and it was so funny because I was slower than the other guys, but the other guys kept crashing behind me. So then I was still leading right at the end at like 10 minutes. And I would have won, but I ran out of fuel. No, I think, yeah, well, I started running out of fuel at the back. So it was like not going properly anymore. And I clipped the chicane. Cody got by, Cody King. So I was in second, and then it ran out right there. So I knew at the back it was running out. That's why I couldn't do the chicane. So that sucked. But it was an awesome. It was so funny. Like at NEO, you have that stadium atmosphere, you know, with mm-hmm. all the people there. So it was fun, like people lying in the track, everyone watching. And then the most ridiculous things would happen. Like I'm leading, like Lee Martin comes, jumps off the track. Robert comes, flips over. This guy comes up, Tebow, like whoever. Like they were all there at some point right behind me, and something would happen. You have to go back and watch that race. It's hilarious.
So, you know what? In celebration of NEO, and I know that NEO was a big inspiration. That's where you met like Isherwood and all that stuff. We're going to give away another RCGP pay-per-view pass. And the question is actually dedicated to the NEO race. So, which racer has won the most NEO buggies? And how many has he won? And you will win an RCGP pay-per-view pass. That's for anybody. First person to tell me that.
Yeah, so JQ's Reedy race where he was leading, same race Ty took out Marlin. I can't, honestly, I cannot remember where I was leading some Reedy race.
You guys got to say the name and number. Okay, Jonathan Wolf wins.
Everyone is saying Tebow.
That's yeah, fine. But he wins it. He won it six times. That you won. You won a RCGP pay-per-view. Jonathan Wolf. He won something the last time. He's in England. He should come race if he isn't. And guess what? My pen's run out of ink. There we go. PPV. I hope I can read all these notes tomorrow. Oh, man, I need to. All right, we got some people tuning in later. JQ, we're going to wrap this up. I'm going to give a few more things away. Then we're going to wrap this up because I know it's late. And you, I thought you'd be more active on her. We have to spice it up. You know what we're going to do? We're going to do a hot laps before you leave.
Yeah,
we're going to do a hot laps before you leave. We're going to give away one more pay-per-view pass to you guys. I think I've given away how many now? Let's see. That's the most I have. You gave away the tires to I can't understand my ride in her. Did we give away the tires already? Who won the tires?
I can't remember anymore. Jay Smoker tried winning them. Steve Harris tried winning them. And then the third.
Oh, Matt Castle. Matt Castle won them.
Yeah.
Wow, what's up with my pen?
Apparently at Reedy race, I was leading for like four out of 5 minutes or something.
That was a long time ago.
It must have been four-wheel drive. Maybe it was a two-wheel drive race. I remember one two-wheel drive race, actually, where it was really close that I was going to win.
I think I remember that. You was all serious about 10 scale for a while there.
Yeah. And then I cased that stupid double.
Yeah. Right you came up short. Typical JQ fashion.
Yeah, as normal. Like my my retirement race with Jessica Paulson. Same thing.
Yeah. You mean the retirement race that really isn't a retirement race?
No, it's a retirement. I'm going to Sweden to the Swedish Nationals and I'm not racing.
She's making some, she's doing pretty good with her little vlogs and stuff like that too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, she's been doing vlogs. She's on TikTok and all that stuff. Her English isn't as good as she's still learning, it sounds like. All right, we're going to give away two more RCGP pay-per-view passes for you guys. And that's going to be the end of the giveaways for us today. Let's see. Let's pick a question. I had a whole bunch of questions here. Okay, I kind of, let's see. I have some RCGP questions. Ooh. This is, that's a little bit too hard. What's the average number? Can you name three past or present RCGP teams? That's easy. If you guys can't get that, first person to get that.
Everyone's going to know that.
Well, the first person to get it. The first person to write three. Let's go. Did we freeze?
Did we lose our chat?
I don't know. Hello, can you guys hear us in the chat?
There we go.
Case Edwards wins.
No.
He was the first one.
No, he's not.
Who?
What? There's no techno in RCGP.
Oh, no. Shit. There is no techno.
You have to name, actually, name the team, not just a car brand. Name the team. Come on.
Yeah. Daiquiri Man. But I think Daiquiri Man won a pay-per-view already. Nemo, Mayako, Beach RC. That's Daiquiri Man named the three. Nemo Racing, Mayako, Race, Beach RC. Are we giving that to Daiquiri Man?
Did he win already or what?
I think he did. I can't remember RC, what he won.
Jars. He also got it. Beach RC, HB Racing, Scampiroso.
Yeah, but I think he won one of these already, too.
Oh, yeah? William Kirk?
William Did Kirk.
Scampiroso, JQSM, BeachRC.
There we go. You win RCGP pay-per-view.
Yeah.
All unless, right, we got unless, one more to give away.
Geary Man didn't, so.
We got one more to give away, and I'm going to try and make this an easy, not an easy question. Let's see. All right. Well, he's already had one in honor of him, so we ain't going to use that one. Okay. This should be fairly easy. This should be fairly easy, and it's up to date. For the last question we're going to ask, what European driver just competed in three Euros, 3 weeks in a row? What was his name, and what were the classes that he ran?
No, what? No, come on. Where did he finish? That's much better.
Okay, who was where it did he finish? Do you have the answers where he finished? And where did he finish? There we go. What three disciplines did he run? Where did he finish? And what's his name?
He ran four, really.
Yeah, I was thinking that too, but they classic.
Okay, so let's just, you just need to name three.
Yeah.
Okay, and three finishing positions. Okay.
What happened? So,
who was it? Most people seem to know. And where did he finish?
We're not saying the classes?
Yeah, you can say the classes.
Which classes did he win? And
which classes did he race and his finishing positions?
Yeah. What you guys got to say?
You can't say Bruno third. Like, what the hell is that?
No, you got to say
a full name, class, and finishing position. And there's three of them. 3 weeks of Euros.
Three. We just had these, everybody.
I'm surprised, actually, that this is...
I think all the Europeans are going to sleep.
Well, here's one. It's not correct, but here's an example. You have the name, you have a class, position, class, position, class, position. It's not correct, but it's real good. We're talking about European championships over the last 3 weeks.
I even forgot about this one.
Here's another one. It's not correct, but get the idea. What?
We forgot about... No, these have to be in a row that he done. There we go.
Yeah.
There we go. Brian Corrin won.
Yeah, and I also like that he used the correct term, vice champion. You know, Brian, he knows what's up.
Brian, so William Kirk won the last one. And Brian Corrin.
two-wheel drive, I can't remember where he finished.
I can't remember where he finished.
Three out of four.
Yeah. All right. Just for you, JQ, vice champion, your favorite. I think they're just playing along now. I think they're just playing along. All right. So then we're going to do some hot laps with JQ because it's his favorite.
Okay. And then segment. Can I go to bed then?
Yes, you can go to bed then. The hot lap section is brought to you by Hi-Tech RCD. Hi-Tech is a leader in RC systems delivering the highest performance and reliability supported by dedicated customer service personnel. The HSBC 93TH1 servers and the DB778WPs have brushless motors, titanium gears, low consumption, constant output, and a metal case. They're manufactured with the high technology from the industrial servo innovation that Hi-Tech provides. The RDX2 Pro charger, which I have right here, can charge up to 4 cell packs in just 45 minutes and provide power to your head heating, charged phone charger, and whatever needs with the USB port. Trust in Hi-Tech, your server and charger headquarters. You can visit them at hitechrcd.com/where-to-buy to find your nearest retailer. All right, JQ, so your favorite section of the podcast, because you got a chance to be rude, right? I am going to say this to you. In three words or less, you have to describe the Tessman and Mayfield incident.
Okay. Three words. I'll do one for Ty, which is watch your back. And then I'll do one for Mayfield, which is wait.
Oh God.
I can't do one for Mayfield. Can we just leave watch your back?
All right, you do it. Here's one. Playground fight.
Playground fight.
Okay. Watch. Dak Rimmel wins. Watch your board.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Excuse me. All right. Hot laps. The Euros.
The Euros, that's it. The Euros, I love Efra.
Okay. You had the Patreon pod from the Euros podcast, you would know. All right, that's a good one. What would I say? Okay, vice champion.
Should not exist.
I thought she was going to be a lot more rude.
In my opinion, does not exist. It's only for losers. There we go. Vice champion, only for losers.
Thank you. Put it on a shirt. Thank you, Andrick. What are you doing up this late, Andrew? It's late in Ireland. It's late. Later, it's almost the same time as JQ. All right.
It's just 11:30.
Is it? 2 hours behind. They're only five behind you. The upcoming worlds in Redovan. Give me three words.
My real retirement.
Okay. 200 episodes of the NNRC.
Absolutely fucking unbelievable.
All right. I had one too. I just remembered. Vice champion is the first loser. The Gandhi wins again. What is Corey talking about?
The Gandhi's going to the Worlds. That's his.
Oh, right. He's all excited about that. He's like, when are you getting there? I'm getting there this time. You're getting there this time. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, Joseph. Hot laps. The industry embracing the drama. Like embracing the drama of Ryan Mayfield and those guys. Because I was surprised that they allowed Mayfield to say what he said afterwards.
Oh, in his own video?
Yeah. Like,
Okay, more of that.
I would agree. Man, I need to get you another hot lap. So I want to get one where you're going to... Okay, Visions Race.
It could also be more of that. Okay. Better next year.
Okay. Invisible speed. Give me three words. Let's see. Self-promote.
Basically must have.
That's pretty good. It sounded like more words, but you got it. You got it. I had to count it. I want to go.
Can I have another one for invisible speed?
Yeah.
Sign up today.
He has a question. Will Europeans attend division race? Probably.
Depends on timing when it's.
Yeah.
They should make an RCGP there.
Yeah. Visions Race.
Nice try, guys.
Oh, my God. I don't want to feel that way, but it is funny. All right, give me a hot laps. Let's get a hot laps from. All right, we're gonna do five hot laps from the audience. So we're gonna pick. No, we'll do three and three. We'll do three from Facebook, three from YouTube. So, give me a question for JQ, a hot laps for JQ, and we'll go. We're gonna end on this.
Need more beer.
Let's get JQ's juicy. Like, he has been quite calm this podcast. I'm surprised. He's tired. So we need, is the chat lagging? We need.
I think so, yeah.
Another book.
No, that's, there we go. That can't be for this.
All right, we got some. Here we go.
Favorite three guests on the podcast. Okay. Actually, Mayfield was good. Shit, I haven't listened to any of the recent ones, but come on, there was one I remember.
I like Jason Snyder.
Good. Yeah, that's the one. Jason Snyder was good. So Mayfield, Snyder, and
you really like the Rona podcast too, because they went science mode. I kind
of Rona for science mode, but I'm sure there's someone else who was. Well, I mean Jeff Keaton as a guest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would say
that's,
so.
That's it.
Cole Ogden's hair. Luxurious. Flowing.
Way too long.
He's embracing it, though. Dacrman, how you meet your girlfriend?
How?
Yeah.
It's easy. Basically, just luck.
16/12% nitro.
Death of nitro.
Yeah, I could have believed that.
Nah, it's not that bad, to be honest. But it's not good either, because the problem with the low nitro percentage in hot weather, it just doesn't run if your engine isn't really good. Like, if you have a worn-out engine, it's not going to run. And that's a bit of a problem.
Okay, I can understand that.
Yeah.
Perfect woman.
Doubtful one exists.
Beta wing.
Should not exist.
Oh my God. But everybody was using it.
Yeah. It should not exist.
Designing a truggy.
Outsourcing to Max.
I know you want to answer this one. American patriotism.
Turned into hatriotism.
I like that one. Yes, we gave away the invisible speed course. Okay, we asked this already, but you said that. Did we? No, feeling after E7.
Mostly massive relief.
I enjoy when you and Craddock were on together. It was fun.
Oh yeah, Craddock was good.
Yeah. Will you have another theme song for the show? I would like for somebody to make a wicked rap song, a hip hop song for the show. That would be great. I asked Lorenzo forever. He never did it. But that'd be great if somebody could do it. Hot mics on drivers for big event coverage, yes or no? I would say yes.
Yeah, we get
some interesting stuff.
It would be so good if we could have the record the radios at RCGP.
Would be epic when you have an epic meltdown. What the fuck was that car doing cutting the fucking track? Jake, that car is 5 seconds ahead of you, right?
No.
About what's in front
of you. I know what you're talking about. It knocked the cone into the track, cut the track, knocked the cone into the track.
See what I mean?
I crashed on the cone.
See? Because you was worried about who cut the track. Or effing me off and giving me a complex about pitting people.
Yeah.
Will JQ beat Jessica Paulson at the Worlds? I'm going to answer that. Highly, highly doubtful.
Yes, we'll be in a different zip code.
Raw E-Nets. I have a better attendance, better than last year. Better than 2021. There we go. He says, by luck, do you mean
alcohol? No, alcohol is social. What is it? Social lubricant, alcohol. But no, I didn't mean that.
No Name RC podcast uncut episodes. Patreon. Yeah, Patreon gets.
Have you released that? Secret episode, the secret rant.
No, I have not. I should.
It was so bad that it's not even for patrons.
Yeah, I haven't. It actually wasn't too bad when I listened to it again.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, here we go. Max Mort, the arrogant one. How can I describe this? The arrogant one is good. What else could we describe, Max? Pissing someone off. I don't have enough words. It's too many
words. I'm trying to do three.
Yeah.
I can't do it grammatically correct, but never doubted comeback.
Okay. That's not what I was going to say. Mine was going to be
never doubted return.
Triggering someone every podcast was what I was going to say.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Someone was asking about the video where I destroyed the Durangos. There's one video, but it was on my Facebook that doesn't exist anymore, where I used a steamroller to flatten a Durango. Maybe it's on my YouTube.
Yeah, Jackson Brunson was there, I remember. Was that Turner's
track? Yeah, it was Schumacher's track. And they had one of those rollers, so we put the Durango on the track and rolled over it. Made a video.
Jessica Paulson. I must race Drake. I want to see her and Ronda Drake race.
Thanks for retirement.
Will you design a two? We got this ass all the time. Will you design a 10 scale buggy?
I mean, it would be. I would like to design 10 scale buggies. Like, if there was a 10 scale company that needed a design, then yeah, I'd be happy to provide one. That would be cool. But I don't see Mayako making 10-scale buggies anytime soon.
Yeah. Salty Joe says you was effing him off in the mic at DNC.
Probably.
What if JQ wins Worlds and Euros?
Well, I won't.
Well, okay. I think he means the Mayako.
If I win through Mayako and Ronnefalk. Well, I think that would have never been done before. Launch a new brand, release a new car, and win those. So, would be cool.
When will we have live telemetry? I got it. I said it right.
I don't know. But that's another thing that would be nice. maybe not for the live show, but for post-produced content to be able to show some data from the cars. Mm-hmm.
He says, I heard you got a bonus points at all RCGP runs if you take out the invisible speed error on the track.
Yeah, you actually get 5 seconds added to your time. So you get visible seconds added.
Is weed a performance enhancer for RC? I don't know. I know like Ritalin is and Adderall.
I don't think weed would be. A beer is.
I don't know.
A beer it definitely is.
This is a great one for Max. Pissing off Barry and Barry Baker's son.
Yeah.
Oh my God. All right. Oh man. All right.
10 scale comparison video.
Oh yeah. Where is that?
Definitely coming. I can't say soon. Definitely coming eventually.
Anyway, you know what, dude? It's been 200 episodes. Thank you for pushing me to start this, number one.
Yeah, and, man.
Thank you for your time. I appreciate that. Thank you guys that all tuned in with us and has been tuning in with us for all 200 episodes in our lives. We appreciate it. We can't do it without you guys. We've had people that supported us from day one. It's been good. We 200 episodes and we're not stopping. We're going to continue to do it. We'll continue to go and hopefully we get bigger and better and do things better. So I hope that we can do that. And we couldn't do it without you guys, man, honestly. And yes, Uncle Edis. What's up, my boy, Eddie Fikes? I got my Uncle Edis right here. Where is it? I always got it. Get you guys your Uncle Edis. I need to take that home. I'm running out at my house. Thank you, 299. Thank you, Dacry, man. I appreciate that. Lefty, go get a tan. I got a tan. Anyway, guys, we thank you for all the support. We thank you for joining us. We couldn't have done it without you guys for the last 200 episodes. And hopefully we get up into those Pulp MX numbers and get up in the 500s and 700s. And we keep doing this for a while. So we greatly appreciate it, JQ. Anything you'd like to say before we leave? Okay, this guy, let's answer this. That's before we go. Let's answer this. Opinions on long e-buggy mains, battery swap out stops. I think that's eventually going to happen, or they're just going to make batteries that can go longer.
I don't think it's going to happen.
I think so. Eventually. E-buggy is like common,
maybe.
Man. Like,
maybe it's for coming. Some endurance racing and stuff. But
right. I think they're going to get to LiPo technology where you can do 20-minute races easily, like without problems.
Oh, one day, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, they can already do. With the big ones, they can probably do 15 minutes now, right?
Right. But I mean like the technology where they get smaller and you can go. Yeah. So it's definitely common. Definitely common. Temps, too, they'll have to make better ESCs and all that stuff, too. Well, good stuff. I know, like, if Oh, JQ, did you see my boat video?
No.
Me, but I was trying to get 100 miles an hour yesterday.
Did it sink?
No, but it flipped a couple of times, and my buddy had to swim in for it. Yeah, well, it doesn't flip itself back over. I have one that does. But it's going to be some work to get to 100 miles an hour. It's not that easy. It's really different. It's really different. I know someone that did a swap in races in e-truggy for nitro truggy mains. That might work too, like to make it for a race against each other. Yeah, but we appreciate you guys' support with the 200 episodes. Thank you guys for joining us. Honestly, we couldn't do it without you guys' support. The NNRC squad around the world, I greatly appreciate it. It's an honor that you guys comment and listen to us.
I thought of a last thing to say.
Okay.
Exclusive.
What's
guess
that?
Guess who's racing the RCGP instead of me? Because I'm retired now. RCGP in UK on JQSM, Invisible Speed, Mayako team.
Is it Pekko?
Yeah, buddy.
Oh, you so got him once.
Sankatin and Pekko Ivonen. So the Finnish kid who made the main at the Euros, he's running Schumacher and for a hobby shop, Hobby Factory in Finland. and he ran an associated at the Euros. He's going to run the Miyako at RCGP.
Pecco's good. He's doing a lot of Euros. He's at the Fiscal Euros now.
I'm gonna be a pit guy at.
Finally, RCGP. We're gonna get to see you be like a proper race engineer.
Exactly.
You are definitely gonna piss somebody off at RCGP.
Why?
Because you're gonna be you're not gonna be wrenching, so you're gonna be pissing them in about everything.
Oh, I'm gonna be wrenching with that. Yeah. I'm gonna make this happen.
All right, we'll see. So then we'll see. But that's good. Pecco is good. It'd be good to see him, meet him finally, and all that type of stuff.
So the next two, can you imagine the next two races? Who says I'm not retired? The next two races, RCGP followed by Swedish Nationals. I am going to both, not racing in either.
It's a miracle. It's a miracle.
Mm. There you go. On that bombshell.
It's a miracle. Yeah, we will. Thank you, guys. We appreciate it. You couldn't do it. Continue to the support. We're probably going to come out next week. I might take a little break this week. My birthday is next week. So might chill out for that. And then I'm off to RGP, England. I'll see you there, Joseph.
Yeah, Kevin Mendes most likely said the wrong year. Go check that. Boom. Said 2000.
I'll have to check that out when it comes up.
Okay.
It was 1999 for Saxton.
Yeah, but I think no one said the right year.
Yeah. Hey, thank you to all the NNRC squad. We can't do it without you. Thank you to all the patrons on the podcast. You guys will get some extra stuff here eventually. And thank you to all the awesome companies that have supported us. I know it's not the easiest thing to support us because we're controversial, but I think what we say has helped the industry and it helps. I think 4 years ago, we wouldn't have seen them embrace the Mayfield and Ty Tasman thing. So it's good to see. So I think we're beating down some paths on that side. I'm happy to see that.
It's helping to inspire the right people who need inspiring.
Yeah, I think so. Thank you to Invisible Speed, TZO 200 Tires, High Tech RC, TNR Fuels, Miyako, Beach RC, Techno RC, Lugs Racing Tires, G-Spec RC Tuning, Papa Willie's Tractortronic, Sun Pedal USA, Racecraft USA, Clinic RC, RCGP, House of RC. Shout out to Dave Ronafuck in his shop, Jared Tebow in his shop, Alexander Hackberg, JQ. Thank you for pushing me to do this. I have enjoyed doing this, and I've found my true passion, which is talking about RC.
Oh, you're very welcome.
Yeah, I couldn't have done it without you, dude. And everybody down here supported. You guys have a good evening. You have a good weekend. And we'll see you maybe next week or maybe in a week's time. We'll do some hijinks. Being as you won't be too busy, maybe we can do some more stuff at RCGP when we meet up. And it looks like I might be coming to the Worlds too. I got to talk to you about that. So okay. With all of that said, everybody, you guys, thank you. Have a good one. And Lefty and JQ are out. For the 200th time, that's a lot of episodes. 200th time. Short outro. You guys have a good one. Thank you all.